a way of life. The team that wins is the team that fights. Being there to cheer and shout is what football games are all about. You should be there, see it, feel it, breathe it. You should be there, see it, feel it, breathe it. Just can't beat being there.
North Adelaide are already onto the ground, and as we approach perhaps the most dramatic and without doubt the final 100 minutes of football in South Australia this year, it's over to our commentators Ian Day, Robert Otey and Peter Marker.
Good afternoon, Australia. Ian Day, your commentator, with me, former state and Glenelg captain Peter Marker. Good afternoon, Peter.
Good afternoon, Ian. How are you?
Great on a day like this, and former Norwood coach and state rover Robert Otey.
Good afternoon, Ian.
Robert, a magnificent sight.
Absolutely fantastic. We're all set for a great game here at Adelaide. Probably that presentation prior to the game was as good as you'd wish to see anywhere, and this stadium being so compact and close augurs well for a great day's entertainment here at Football Park.
For the benefit of interstate viewers, the sight in your screen at the moment is Glenelg. Don't be surprised if we call them the Bays or the Tigers. The Tigers is obvious. The yellow and black, and of course the Bays come from the Glenelg Bay, in which area they are but. And North Adelaide, well, they have called the Roosters. They are red and white, and the Roosters comes from the cock of the north. North Adelaide in the northern areas of Adelaide, so they could be called the Roosters or the Northerners. North Adelaide, Glenelg Tigers or the Bays. And they've got some brilliant players in them, none better. Well, then, just having a look there at the North coach, Michael Nunan, for Peter Marker, none better out there than Stephen Kernahan.
Well, there he is, number four, Ian. He's probably regarded as certainly the best player in South Australia. Carlton have been chasing him for several years. They signed him. I think the good doctor, Dr. Edelston, wants him in his stable. May not get him. May even cost more than the good doctor's prepared to pay. He's a fantastic player.
Well, the most senior player in the game, Robert Otey.
Peter Carey. And Peter Carey is the captain of Glenelg. He played in their last grand final in 1973. He played as a centre-half forward, but today he'll be rucking, and of course he's rucked a lot of his career. Holds the club record. He's played some 373 games, including 17 state games for South Australia. He's captained the team in the last two seasons, and now this season in a great premiership attempt.
Umpires in charge, Rick Kinnear and Laurie Argent, and we're standing by for the anthem. Former Woodville, North Melbourne champion, McGarry medalist, Brownlow medalist, Malcolm Blight, a huge figure in South Australia, strides out the centre field for the toss. A champion, and a popular champion.
He's getting a wonderful ovation to Ian, and I think that's a credit to the man. And this is last year. He's given it up, of course. He captained South Australia and kicked 100 goals at the age of 35. What a magnificent achievement.
Peter Carey on your left, the captain of North Adelaide. David Teller, number four, has won the toss, elected to kick towards the lake end. That's the big bow of the lake at the left-hand side of your screen. Robert Otey, the wind is worth,
I reckon, about 10 metres on the kick once you get past the centre end. Of course, here at Football Park, near the goals, it's not too bad quite often. The shelter of the stands and the covers, the arena, of course, sunken down. And I think that both teams will score both ends because they're both great ball getters, good skilled teams, and they'll be scoring both ends of the ground. I don't think the wind is going to affect the game all that much.
The Bay's just warming up at the northern end. Rover Tony McGuinness is being chased by Geelong and Footscray, probably the most explosive player on the ground, number eight, a McGarry medalist. And when he gets the ball, you watch those little legs zip. A fine player, and he can cart the ball from one end of the ground to the other at amazing pace. I can remember in the second semi-final, he got the ball on the half-back line. He bounced the ball about half a dozen times to the half-forward line and then went for home and kicked a magic goal.
Chris McDermott's another top player. There he is. He's not the prettiest of footballers, but of course, pretty footballers aren't always effective. This man certainly is. He also has been chased nettily by the Fitzroy Football Club. But perhaps a message to Carlton: if you want Stephen Kernahan, sign McDermott up, because they're very good friends.
Of course. Stephen Copping, of course, he returned from Essendon in 1984. Not that tall a player, plays in the forward lines, had a lot of kicks. He's kicked 268 goals for the Tigers. Very experienced player, and they'll be looking for a big performance from him this afternoon.
John Riley, a player that's been chased by Footscray, Robert, and a very fine one. Don't be fooled by the greying hair when we do get him in picture. He's a very talented player. He's an atomic physicist, would you believe? It's difficult to say, but what I must tell you, there's some brains between the two ears. But he's gone prematurely grey, but he's a very fine player. Best on ground performance in the preliminary final. There he is in screen now, number one, 163 senior games.
Tony Antrobus has just left the ground for some reason or other. He's a diminutive rover, a very explosive player, which North Adelaide have a couple of players with great power. He's not a big lad. He's won a McGarry medal. He's gone down and left the oval for just a couple of moments for some reason or other, probably to get a bit of strapping on. But he's a very vital cog, and of course his clash with Tony McGuinness today will be an absolute beauty.
Well, they're both former McGarry medalists, of course. He's gone off the ground. Let's hope he comes back on. Of course, there's Big Parsons in screen. He's a basketballer come footballer. Phillips having a kick, and there's Andrew Jarman, a 19-year-old lad who's really got the brains of a senior footballer. He's averaged 16 kicks and 13 handballs per week this year, so 29 disposals, a magnificent performance.
Another fine performer, Matthew Campbell, number 25 for the Northerners. Matthew plays at centre wing, sometimes centre half forward flank, a South Australian representative, 73 senior games. He's also been a fine player during the year. He has averaged 14 kicks and 8 handballs, and he's got one of the fastest pair of legs in the league.
David Tiller, the captain of North Adelaide for the last two seasons, David Tiller. He's a run-on player, long, raking left foot kick, likes to get out on his own, and as most players do, I suppose, but he can certainly make a mess of a game if he gets a few kicks out there. His kicks are very strong. He's played 171 games, and he made his debut in 1977.
Well, they've certainly got some great footballers, North Adelaide. They're, in terms of experience, they're nowhere near as experienced as Glenelg is in terms of finals games. Glenelg's players have played 176 finals matches, and there are several. In fact, there are 5 that have played 12 or more finals matches. North Adelaide, on the other hand, can only aggregate 69 finals matches between them, and in fact, only a couple of players have got 4 finals matches. So experience is on the side of North Adelaide. The sides have met 3 times this year. In the first round, North Adelaide beat Glenelg at Glenelg's home ground, the only side to do it this year. The second round at Prospect Oval, North Adelaide's home ground, Glenelg won. But in the big one in the second semi-final, it was a wonderful game of football. Of course, Glenelg got up.
Yes, Peter, a brilliant performance. North Adelaide coming good at the right time of the season. They won their first 11 games, then went down the hole, lost their next 6, but started to gather their game together and played wonderfully well to win last week against the fast-finishing West Adelaide. But everything in readiness for a magnificent game. You could not get a better day. There's a little breeze going from the south to the north. The turf in magnificent condition. It's almost putting green smoothness out there. And I can tell you that South Australians are very jealous of their footy park. Tony Antrobus just heading out onto the ground again. He went down into the rooms. Antrobus, who was the McGarry medalist last year, has had a lot of problems with ankles in previous times or in recent games, and in fact he was in doubt last week as to whether he'd play at all. But he's a very important player. I think he's been looked at by Essendon, Peter, isn't he?
Yes, in fact he's signed by Essendon, Ian, and I know that Kevin Sheedy is at the match here today, and Kevin wants to have a close look at him. He's got 1 year of his contract to go, but whilst Essendon are not keen to induce a breach of that contract, they're still keen to look at him.
Peter, I just hope that as a former State and Glenelg captain, you remain objective during the course of the afternoon. Stand by for the anthem.
Our home.
magnificent scene. A packed house, 50,000 plus, Robert.
There's been a couple of changes. Peter Carey started in the forward pocket end, the big ruckman. He's down there alongside with Adam Garton. Of course, Garton's been a find for Glenelg during the final series, and Copping's up on centre right wing with John Riley next to him.
Minor Premier North Adelaide fronts Glenelg in the 1985 Grand Final. A packed house, 50,000 people plus, a perfect day for football. Henward in there against Redden. The umpire has picked up a free kick immediately. And it's the Bays, I think, to go into attack through Stringer. A high tackle. Umpire Kinnear in charge. Jack side of the centre line to put the Bays into attack. It's a poor kick for the half forward line, but fortuitously it finds Maynard. Maynard for the Bays, still inside the centre square. Off goes Garton. Carey at the back there. Kernahan in front. The ball is thumped clear, trying to get through his arm field. The left leg back towards Phillips. Robertson over the top. Cleverly, Tillett couldn't. Getting back on it now quickly is Stringer. Backup support coming in his brother. That is Wayne Stringer. Over the half forward line, the half back flanker steadies. Put the kick underway. It's going to be short. Carey can't quite get there. A magnificent rebound effort by Stringer. But the ball is offline and the first score of the final, a point.
Probably a little mistake there by David Robertson. A little bit insecure in his ability to take that ball, just knocked it on, and Glenelg were on it like a flash. That was a great rebound.
Great opening by the Bays too. Redden under the ball, Henward from behind, smashes away. There's a high tackle. The free kick was on then, it wasn't the first time. Alan Stringer picks up his second free kick for the match in the first minute and a half. The lead is on from Adam Garton, but Stringer goes to the pocket looking for Copping. Riley in front, he's got the ball. He knows where it is. This game at halfback last week in the preliminary final was probably the best ever seen here. He puts it out wide looking for Matthew Campbell. David Kernahan goes for the thump over the top and it's out of bounds.
What a great mark that was, Peter. Under all sorts of pressure from Copping. Just keeps his feet, John Riley, just won't fall over.
He knows where the ball is. It's on a string. If you want to stop him getting it, just cut the old string. Matthew Campbell had to throw that ball away. North Adelaide have not opened well. Simons run through half forward, over the top of both players. Arnold, one against three. The kick is off the ground, but it is into the pocket, and we will see a throw in. Paul Arnold, who's got the job at fullback on Adam Garton, who really is an apprentice full forward. Played 2 weeks there, and he's kicked 11, so apprentice he may be, but very good, notwithstanding. Arnold's handball is to Kernahan, unintentionally, of course. Marshall holding the ball, good tackle. Michael Armfield's free kick, so that's the first free kick to North Adelaide.
The Roosters half-back flanker from the back pocket edges the ball out of defence. Up towards Redden at centre wing. Stringer in front, can't get there. Robertson, the handball away, not good. Redden likewise, Antrobus, backup support needed. Back to Jarman having his first touch. On the left leg goes the 19-year-old up towards Hart on the half-forward line. Seabone getting back for the Bays, running to the ground. And the free kick will go to the Bays centre-half back. John Seabone, who spent some of the season playing full forward, now ensconced at centre-half back, drives towards the half-forward line. Maynard, a beautiful set. Back of the pack, he's off. Folding over the half-forward line, puts it up towards Copping. He's clear. In front, however, the mark has been taken by the Bay Clarin McGuinness about 45 metres out. Kicking into the breeze, averaging 22 disposals for the season, might be struggling for distance. McGuinness, a nice looking kick, holding up a little offline in any case, and the Bays register their second point.
Well, if in fact North Adelaide have the advantage of any breeze, which they may not, it's hard to tell here, you wouldn't know from the first couple of minutes, because Glenelg in charge. Antrobus runs it over the top now. North Adelaide will try and run it out. They do, in fact, through Wheelie. Up it goes to Bennett. He plays it up now. Here goes Robertson. He's one of the fastest players you'll ever see. He runs through half forward. That ball's coming back. Oh, it's a goal. Robertson's got the first one of the game. North Adelaide go forward once and they get a big one. One goal to Glenelg, 2 points.
And that's what North Adelaide are all about. In last week's preliminary final, it was David Robertson at a much sharper angle than that, that punched a goal home and then hit the post with a similar play. But Peter Bennett's mark on centre wing then, when he gave it across to Robertson, the powerful North Adelaide player who rests on the half forward flank, where he changes with David Tiller running up the ground and powering that kick and just letting the wind fade it into the goal. Magnificent bit of play, and that's why North Adelaide have kicked 10 and 11 goals in a couple of quarters this year.
A shot there of the Bay coach Graham Cornes in his first year with the Bays. Coached South Adelaide last year. Kernahan, that's David Kernahan. He's the young brother of Riley, Stephen Riley. Over to Stephen Hay. Built like a bull. Over the half back line, a long kick to the half forward line. Out in front is Murphy. Over the top, Parsons. Not Parsons. Really? That's Brealey, and he's got the ball 40 metres out in front. John Brealey came into the preliminary final last week when North Adelaide dispensed with their services of their regular full forward in Grenville Dietrich. Puts it up towards full forward. Parsons! Oh, what a fine mark. He's going to be difficult. 200 centimetres. The former Taswegian, averaging 1.5 goals per game, took a big one. The angle is evident. The distance is not a problem. Neither is the accuracy. And North Adelaide have got 2 goals. The Bays, 2 points.
So Michael Parsons, resembling, of course, that big fellow that plays for Essendon that we saw on national television last week, Paul Salmon. Parsons, 6'9" in the goal square, a former basketballer, a great mover. He's got great movement around the ground and in that forward line. He had a great second semi-final when he went onto the ball and played some good footy, even though Glenelg got up that day. Now that he's resting at full forward, if North Adelaide can attack the goal square with confidence, they'll be right.
Coach Cornes in screen again. He'd be a little bit tense, one would imagine. Stephen Hayes in the back pocket. Out in front of Peter Carey. Mark well. Sanders has got that. North Adelaide's disposal. Extremely good, as well you might imagine. On that occasion, not so good, though. Him went under the ball. Couldn't mark it, but he backs his own play up. Comes back now to a bunch of players. Matthew Campbell in front. He takes the mark easily. Tiller will get it next, and he kicks a long way to give the big chap a chance. Parsons under the ball. Gibbs couldn't mark it. Off-hands it comes. Oh, Andrews threw it out too quickly. Simon's intercepted and passed beautifully back to David Kernahan. Well, the Andrews movement then was not certain. Redden is behind the pack, and the big chap too grabs it and takes the mark. Kernahan was edged under the ball then beautifully by Wielding. There's 15 metres to boot. That will go against McDermott. Redden will be on centre wing now for the kick forward. Well, Glenelg opened up beautifully in the first 2.5 minutes, tacking against the breeze. They looked extremely fluent. But of course, North Adelaide have gone ahead twice for 2 goals. And that's what the game's all about, scoring. Oh, poor kick again, North Adelaide. And it's marked by a former North Adelaide player, Wayne Stringer.
Wayne Stringer, brother playing centre, Ballard. Wayne Stringer, the elder of the two, drives to the half forward line, looking for Copping, can't quite get there. Tony Hall through, tried to sweep it over to a teammate, couldn't get there, and Phillips comes away. Red, Jarman, Hart through half forward line, a long kick going in, getting back on it, Parsons, but he won't make it. The ball went over his head and through for the minor score. The Northerners 2-1, the Bays 2 points.
I'll tell you, Alan Stringer nearly took Redden out of the stadium then, but about 30 seconds after it, Redden gave him one straight back, right on the edge of the chin. So the big farmer from Oraru certainly won't cop it without giving it back. Darryl Hart, the former Bulldog, he's got it at right half forward. He centres the ball to give the big timber a chance. Parsons, gee, they were over his shoulder. The umpire unsighted. Ross Gibbs, who's been a brilliant back pocket player this year, tries to kick it out. Not to real advantage, though. Armfield's way up from half-back. Sanders is in the pocket, and he takes the mark. North Adelaide looking good, but they won't derive much benefit from tacking into that pocket. Very difficult to score from there. He centres the ball, the breeze bringing it back. Henwood's marking uncontested. Oh! The player is down. Toothy is being spoken to. Parsons is decked. The question is, will he get up? Here's a replay of it. He goes down. Number 26 in screen. Now will pass kick. I think the big chap's recovering, albeit slowly. Ian, did you see it?
No, Peter. In the screen there on the replay, it looked as though that he just ran into the back of Duthie, but you didn't see whether or not there was an arm or an elbow that went up. But Parsons went down like a wet paper bag. But, you know, the anticipation of a free kick usually makes them recover pretty quickly.
Well, they love the ball. Certainly, Parsons lining it up for his second goal, and he struck through the middle with that one. North Adelaide 3-1 now, Glenelg 2 points.
So Michael Parsons receiving that kick coming in, and as Peter said on the earlier play, the only way they're going to stop him in the air is to interfere with him, and if the umpires aren't prepared to pay that interference, then there's a chance that they'll stop him getting goals. But when the ball comes in one out, as it did then, he had the opportunity to run at it. And of course, what Duthie did when he went to take his run up, Duthie just blocked in front. And of course, that's shepherding when the ball's not within 5 metres, and that's what he was penalised for. He probably winded himself slightly.
North Adelaide 3-1, the Bays 2 points, and we've lost the football. The boundary umpire has to go to the line to get another one, just as the first one returns to the arena. I don't think they'll worry about that one at the moment. Henwood is being spoken to by the runner. The Bay's in a little trouble in the first 10 minutes. 3-1 plays 2 points. Henwood, the former Western Australian player, in opposition to Red. Good bounce. Henwood, McDermott, Wayne Stringer. The Bay's go to the half forward line. Kernahan got the bad bounce, but a free kick is going against Carey, I think you'll find. And it goes to Stephen Hay, who comes up holding the shoulder. The defensive corner of the square. A high, long kick, a nice kick, a ground covering kick to the half forward line. Aerial ping pong, Phillips, Maynard. Appeared to be legged somewhat, but the umpire will come in and bounce on the half forward line for North Adelaide.
Well, we're 11 minutes into this first quarter now. There's a push paid. Glenelg will come away with it. Simons is on centre wing. He's a very good player. Normally picks out a man upfield. Didn't on that occasion. Oh, Kernahan. The ball came through to him beautifully. Garton. Now Marshall. Here's a go for the Bays. Oh, the handball's up wide. Well, McGuinness was in the square waiting for it, and Marshall fluffed the handball, so Glenelg miss a big opportunity here.
Oh yes, Peter. David Marshall would be one of the best kicks in South Australia too. In hindsight, he should have had a shot. He probably thinks that now himself. Matthew Campbell off the half back line. Short to Robertson, centre wing. Harden, centre field, wants the ball. That's where it went. Oh, he lost his footing. McDermott did well to get his hand to it. Stringer against Hart. Hart will need support. Can't get out. Player stack up. And umpire Kinnear will come in and bounce. Umpires Kinnear and Argent. Obviously the best umpires in South Australia. That's why they're umpiring the grand final. Certainly two of the most experienced. Red. The tap down to Jarman. Can't get it out. Onto the left leg of Robertson and a half forward line coming to meet it. Antrobus looking for a lead now. He gets one, but he's going in long, looking for the tall arms of Parsons. Parsons up there, fisted away, getting back on it all, lost his footing. Now Stringer against Tiller. And Stringer takes the easy way and lets the ball trickle out of the club.
Once again, Hart was caught in the centre of the ground by calling the ball to him when the percentage play wasn't on. It's in the forward pocket now, though. There's another mix-up of players. Parsons and Henwood down on this occasion. Hart can't get boot to ball. Glenelg player pushed in the back by Parsons, and it's his free kick. In fact, it's Wayne Henwood, who came to Glenelg from Western Australia this year, and his recent form has been excellent. And he might find the tall timber of the Roosters a bit tough today. Kernahan's under the ball. The big chap up, can't mark the ball, but scooping it up. Simons. Now Maynard. Maynard puts it up forward, but gee, the kick was into an open space rather than to a player running to it. It's now out in Glenelg's half-forward area. Half-forward right. The Bay's yet to get a goal. They're going against a breeze. We don't know how strong it is yet. In ruck, it'll be Wieldy against Stephen Kernahan for the Tigers. Kernahan with the backhand. Phillips cleverly to Antrobus. He kicked it high to the centre of the ground. A misbounce there. Carey in the game. David Kernahan sweeps it out now to Seabone. He puts it up very high. Riley under the ball. Beautiful jump. judgment, Stephen Riley. It wasn't. Poor football, in fact. Had the chance to give it properly, didn't. Alan Stringer, copying. Marshall now. This time he has a kick. Kernahan, Wilney. Wilney kept his eyes on the ball beautifully. He's run over from behind. Now Kernahan. He lines it up, and he's offline. Glenelg, oh, he's got another kick. I didn't see it, Robert.
They're pushing the back after when he went to kick it. He was pushed, and the umpire's paid to push him the back. He took his time. He waited until the very last second. He gave himself an opportunity to get a free kick. It's a little bit doubtful whether he should have, but he did. He was pushed in the back, and that's a free kick.
Well, not a great deal in it. Stephen Kernahan now in the right forward pocket has an opportunity to keep Glenelg in touch. He'll aim for the left. Missed it, dragged it, pushed it out too far to the left. So Glenelg inaccurate. 4 points to North Adelaide, 3-1.
I think it's David Wilde that's been given the job on Kernahan. Certainly is. He's a very close checker. Arnold, a dash at full back to Stephen Riley. Riley, a long kick, centre wing. Carey getting back on the ball. Wayne Stringer over the top. Slips the ball out to David Kernahan. Changes tack. Comes back towards the half-forward line. Simon's there, but up goes Hay. Barges his way through, drives it on. Oh, that's a 65-metre kick up towards full forward. Getting back on it, Brealey. Luthi can't get there. And the umpire says the ball will be thrown in.
Yeah, and that kick there, a little bit careless by Hay, actually. He's a prodigious kicker, and he's kicked it into the blind, or the dead pocket, we'd call it. He should have perhaps straightened up for the square.
3-1. The umpire has seen a free kick there going to North Adelaide. Mick Ratton, about 35, 40 metres out. Not confident of making the distance, puts it up for Parsons. Parsons against Henwood, thumps the ball away. Hart runs into trouble, holding the ball. And the free kick will go the way of Ross Gibbs. Ross Gibbs, the former West Perth player. Let's have a look at it in replay. Good tackle, he appeared to drop the ball. That's the way the umpire saw it. And as I said, the former West Perth player who came to South Australia in 83, edges the ball out of defence.
Redden and Kernahan, the punch away comes. Immediately the kick forward by Maynard. Riley and Copping. Riley lost his footing late. Kernahan missed the run of the ball. Copping back on it. Here's a chance for Alan Stringer. Right hand ball to McDermott. This is a go for Glenelg. The kick not a good one. Oh, Hayes under that. Away go. Defender. He should have stopped. He was off. And he fell over. And once that happens, it's curtains. Well, what a mistake to get Glenelg back into it. Stephen Hay, who'd been playing very well, has given McGuinness the chance, and he won't miss. Glenelg's first goal. 1-4. North Adelaide, 3-1.
Because that's a very important goal to Glenelg. Stephen Hay has played on just about every time he's had a kick in this first quarter today, in an effort to get North Adelaide mobile with the breeze and blast the ball, because he's a prodigious kick. But on that occasion, he was caught, he slipped. I think the oval is fairly firm, and players having a little difficulty in changing direction. And when the Glenelg players came upon him, he slipped, lost his balance, and then straight away a free kick for holding the ball, because he did try to blast. So therefore, Glenelg in with a good chance now.
3-1 North Adelaide, 1-4 Glenelg. 9 points the difference, 18 minutes into the 1985 Grand Final. Stringer again, up towards McGuinness. Now watch him go. Caught on the right foot, which is his wrong foot. He hooks towards the line. Coming out to meet it is Garden. Can't keep it in play. And it'll be put back about 35 metres around.
It's interesting that they've started Tony McGuinness in that forward pocket. Again, they've done it for the whole year. But he's an explosive player, and he'll be pretty handy from that second quarter, Ian, if he gets out onto the ball.
Kernahan against Wilde. John Riley, high tackle, and the North Adelaide player will get the free kick. Gives it across to Tiller, looks for Antrobus at centre wing. North Adelaide running over into attack now. Changes tack, he's going to get one down. Down he goes, a vicious tackle, a punch tackle. Up comes Antrobus. McDermott, the culprit. In goes Antrobus, all right in front of the
at McDermott. He's not prepared to do it in the final, but that was a reportable offence.
And Trovis puts the ball up now for passes at the back of the pack. The big fellow comes up. Carey in trouble, pushing the back. And Carey gets the free kick. Elects to play on to Gibbs. Gibbs has got nobody kicked to at all. He's got to run the ball out of defence. Maynard thought about David Kernahan, now kicked high to the half forward out. Looking out there for Stephen Kernahan. But over the top comes Stephen Riley and takes the mark on the half back line.
Yes, he's taken a couple of good marks too, Ian. The kick up forward now. No one there for North Adelaide. Coming in late was Peter Bennett. But a little bit too late. Well, that was certainly a pretty vicious sort of a tackle executed there by Chris McDermott. But still, it's grand final time. Away it goes now. Tiller, Campbell doubles back. They're tacking into that forward pocket. North Adelaide, it's not paying off for them either. There's a bad tackle. It's a high running back. Plus 15 against Tony Antrobus.
Same two players.
Oh well, tip for tat. Eye for an eye. They're still aiming for Kernahan. Under the ball this time. Far too far under it. McDermott's pace, McGuinness's pace is blistering. They're trying to run it out north, but they can't. It's close to the line. It's over now, so we'll see a throw in. Left half forward flank for Glenelg. And Ian, I think Glenelg has steadied in the last 7 or 8 minutes.
I think they were shocked by the Northerners' pace, Peter, but Kernahan can't get into the game yet. But you won't keep him down all day, I can tell you. Armfield got it there from Jarman. Kicks long. Carey getting back on the ball. And Vic Super takes a fine mark.
I notice that Mick Meaton's playing back on Carey, but Carey's still reading it too well. Often the big ruckman getting loose back in defence there on his own, but Redden's staying with him, but Carey's too good.
373 games, plenty of experience. Bennett, Hart, North Adelaide going in again. Oh, the short kick by Sanders was not good, and it's McDermott who sends him out of defence. The bay to the half forward line, coming across a fine mark taken by Riley. Once again, this is Stephen Riley. Riley from the half back line. Kernahan starting to get perhaps a little frustrated as the ball goes to the half forward line. Fine mark, Redden. Redden half forward line. Here's a chance now. Campbell runs into trouble. Tango's out. Puts one up now for Parsons. Parsons against Henwood. Thumped away again. First recover will be Antrobus in the pocket. Gets into trouble. Ducks ahead. The umpire set play on. Hart shoots for the woodwork, but the ball is offline. And another point is recorded. North Adelaide 3-2. The Bays 1-4.
Tony Antrobus still finding that first reflex move a little bit difficult. He grabs the ball and still wants to hold on to it to get into a space, and it's not always easy to do that. Robertson and Hall. Hall's the taller of the two. He plays on. Robertson's got him. Oh, the handball astray. Tiller. The handball to Phillips. Phillips has got Jarman flanking him. He takes his time, but he's a brilliant player. Oh, he's missed it with the kick. Chance now for North Adelaide as they try to run it through half forward. Brearley, Robertson, he kicked the first goal. He puts it up in the air, prodigious kick. Parsons is there, also Henwood, the punch away comes. The big chap's got plenty of pace. He'll probably get there first. Campbell, Hart, oh, he dropped it. One hand up, tries to push it out. Two, they're making mistakes, North Adelaide. Ross Gibbs ducks the head, and umpire Kinnear will bounce it.
They won't pay holding the ball, and that decision when they duck down for the defender. If you're in defence, you'll get a free kick, but up in front of goal, they make it a bit harder.
Beautiful tap down, Peter Carey to Ross Gibbs. Under the ball, Armfield. Maynard. Marshall. Copping's in front of Riley. Can't quite get to the drop of it. There'll be a throw in centre wing.
3-2 North Adelaide, 1-4 the Bays. Out of side throw in. Kernahan 4 against Wildey 23. Good tap down to McDermott. Alan Stringer, Maynard, Simons wants it, but it's going in towards Gardon. Big fella up. Simons going to get the crumbs. That's one tackle. Slips it out. Copping ought to be a goal. Open goal coming up. Fine shot. Beautiful handball. Copping first. The Bay second. They trail North Adelaide 2-4 to 3-2.
It's It's a very important goal to Glenelg. They've gone very well into the wind. In fact, they've had one more scoring shot than North Adelaide. The wind fairly strong. And Stephen Cobbing, recovering from the half-forward flank where he'd competed for a ball out there just a few moments ago, got back to receive that ball much quicker than John Riley, his opponent. And he's caught Riley well up ground then. And now Stephen Cobbing, a little bit of experience getting into the game and recovery and picking up a good goal.
Kerry and Ruck now got the tap out. Tackle applied. Out goes Tiller. Campbell with a long ball into the forward area. Nobody home for North Adelaide. Henwood easily. Glenelg in charge at the moment. Here's a go now, Tony Simons.
Henwood's playing full back at the moment.
Thank you, Robert. Maynard now with a quick kick away. Marshall and Stephen Kernahan. Well, the Northerners have dropped away. Out comes Garton. Staying down Riley. Now Hart. Robertson's the runner. He's one of the quickest runners in football. Through the centre he goes. Kicks it out to the leading Parsons. He's way out on his own, and that's a beautiful setup. Now this will test the big chap. He's kicked two, but they've both been from close range. North Adelaide, by the way, kicking to the northern end with the aid of probably a breeze that's worth, say, three goals. Oh, bad kick from Parsons. Off the side of the boot. Tony Hall couldn't mark it. The umpire will bounce it. Coach Mike Nunan would have been happier 10 minutes ago. Jeff Paul, his assistant, is flanking him. Parsons will take the tap for North Adelaide. No, really it'll be Carey. Shot the handball out. Hard up the ground. Oh, he's kicked a goal, Hart.
Oh, I don't think it was Hart. I think it was the player came into the side. May have been Green. He's really on the far side.
Carey went for the handball and dribbled along the ground, and so North Adelaide have got one through the big chap, John Brearley.
Yes, John Brearley took over in the side, then from Dietrich, who pulled out, lack of fitness, and that was a great tap down. It was well intercepted though. Carey couldn't quite get it through and hit Hart's knee, and then it just fell out of Carey's hand, and Brearley recovered to kick the goal.
4-2 to 2-4. Maynard under pressure, Robertson in on top. And umpire Argent in for the belt. 4-2 to 2-4. The Northerners by 10 points. Into time on in the 85 Grand Final. Carey against Redden. Redden's tap away. Finds Antibus under pressure. Kernahan can't get it, but he's going to get a free kick. This is David Kernahan, the younger of the two. McGuinness is out wide. Loose jacking North Adelaide. McGuinness on his natural left leg. He likes it from here. Puts it underway. Going in long. Going in and hit the woodwork, I think. Gee, he's kicked some brilliant goals this season. On that occasion, he was about 10 centimetres away. 2-5, Glenelg, 4-2, North Adelaide.
Glenelg certainly on top. Arnold brings it out to grandstand side. Stephen Riley was pushed just as he jumped. So it's his free kick. Five kicks now to John Stephen Riley, the brother of North Adelaide's John Riley. Robertson up, couldn't mark the ball. Redden tapped it, Antrobus, that was a better movement. Here they go again, North Adelaide. Robertson will take off through half forward. Beautiful kick to the square. Really gets back. The punch away comes, the umpire says play on. Just a cool Ross Gibbs in the back pocket, swings it wide. Up goes Worley with a great marker. There's a Barney on in the pocket. Really it is, and Duthie. The big chap Parsons wants it. The ball is going to be brought back though for another kick.
That was good play by Parsons. The umpire's going to let that brawl go on. It didn't make any difference. Parsons took advantage of the fact. He went down the ground, but Laurie Argent at centre wing decided he'd call the game up. I think the great thing about having two umpires is the game can go on. Anyone that wants to have a fight, they can keep fighting as it runs around them.
So they should have three, Robert. Wheelie goes in long. Parsons won't get near that one. Henwood went up very high. Hart again. Well, the kick's to no one. Ross Gibbs in the pocket. Really won't catch him. A touch kick now to David Kernahan. A push in the back to boot.
Good Mark Kernahan in doubt during the week with a very sore shoulder. Report said that he had to do 200 push-ups on Thursday night to prove his fitness. The way he got his hands up then suggests that he's okay. Kernahan in front. That's what he's noted for. Averaging 11 marks for the season, but kicks into the man. Not a good one. Hay getting back on it. Whips out along the handball. Antrobus. Watch him beat loud in defence. Kicks long to pull forward. Free kick upfield. Antrobus, who loves a scrap, against Stephen Kernahan on that occasion, as I said, maybe getting just a little frustrated, and passes, that's from the reverse angle, shoot for goal, about 30 metres out, kick in, hit the woodwork again, hit for 10, both teams have hit the post once. North Adelaide 4-3, Glenelg 2-5, close to quarter time in the 85 Grand Final.
The big chap Parsons is causing some headaches up there, but I tend to feel that if he leads out into those pockets, he's going to find goals pretty hard to come by. Jarman in front, Kernahan off hands, fell over and got a free kick. Well, the umpires are sometimes fooled by the quick fall over. Now Simons. Up goes McDermott from behind, but it's the man in front that'll be paid. Stephen Riley goes to the outer side of the ground. Seabohm, Bennett, Roy held ground beautifully to play on now. Jarman, he sweeps around the pocket, hooks it in, up they go, and a punch up, hits the post, and another point for the Northerners. 4-4 now, leading Glenelg 2-5.
Clever defensive work then, I think it was by Henwood. It's got a hand to it, spoiled the mark, forced the behind. Gibbs, uncertain where to go. Carey lumbers off to the outer side. That's where Gibbs will go, a fine kick. Carey's going to get a leap at this one, beautifully passed. Carey looking for running support. Off goes the flash, McGuinness. Tango's out of trouble beautifully, fires out the pass, looking for Kernahan. Redden found it, now Stephen Riley. He defends to the half forward line, siren sounds. End of the first quarter in the 1985 Grand Final, North Adelaide 4-4, Glenelg 2-5.
The game, Graham, was that experience would Stephen Kerner have on the game? He's got plenty of height. We haven't seen a lot of him so far. David Wilde's done a superb job.
Excellent. Stephen Kernahan, we said before the match, was the key to the game for the Bays. Hasn't done much so far. Two marks for the entire first quarter. But he'll do better. He'll warm up to the task.
For the second quarter, here's Ian Day, Peter Marker and Robert Oatey.
Umpire Kinnear to get the second quarter underway. Redden or Carey. I thought he thought about it then. Yes, he did think about it.
Yes.
Umpire Larry Argent was very close to that. Big super, I think, missed the ball and hit something else then. Peter Bennett. Seabohm with superb judgment normally, plays it in front of him, but he's lost it now. Matthew Campbell picks up the crumbs, he goes in short to the big chap and finds him. Dear, oh dear, I don't think he could kick one from here. He could probably shoot a basketball from that spot, but I don't know if he could kick a football.
That wind blows fairly strongly through those two goals at this end of the ground. Very tough kick.
I think that's what he's looking at, Robert. He's considering the breeze at the moment. Got his windometer out. Oh, he's gone for the check side. Gee, made a fairly good attempt at it. Got the point. So North Adelaide now 4-5, leading Glenelg 2-5.
Pretty difficult to check side with the breeze against you. He's coming in from his right to left. Nevertheless, he tried. 2-5, plays 4-5. Ross Gibbs gets a lead from Carey to the outer side. Screws a magnificent kick right up towards Carey. Thumps it over his head. Marshall at the back of the pack, within there is Armfield. Quickly now Stringer. Got the kick away, albeit a little slowly. The ball goes to the line for a throw-in on the outer side. Alan Stringer been in fine form in recent times. Great duel anticipated between he and number 17, Andrew Jarman. Carey against Redden. Carey in front. Redden could have got the tap. Marshall can't get through. Redden back to Armfield, slips out the handball. The running far is Phillips. North Adelaide into attack again. Ball lobbing short, fortuitously so. Out on the outer side. North Adelaide to go into attack now through Brealey. Comes in towards Parsons. Felt away there by Henwood. North Adelaide a chance. Antrobus whips out a handball. Open goal. Lay down Mazzia. Sanders. Fine goal. Beautifully set up Antrobus. Sanders first goal. North Adelaide 5-5, the Bays 2-5.
They're certainly reading it well off hands. Big pass is making the front spot and they're not frightened to attack him either. He's got a bit of movement, the big fellow. He's not just standing in the goal square, particularly with this ball coming into the breeze now, making front position, as did his teammate out on that half-forward flank. And they got it in there at Antrobus, is reading the ball well off the ground. Ross Gibbs a little bit loose, I noticed, in the first quarter. But the bouncers didn't favour the short blokes in front of the pack, but on that occasion it did.
Glenelg is going to bring Scott Salisbury onto the ground, and he no doubt will come out to do a stopping job. Now Tiller changes direction. Oh, how did Jarvan get out of that? Tiller. I don't know how North Adelaide did that. Not much attack on the body as Armfield kicks it forward. Ross Gibbs in front reads it beautifully. The ball just follows that man. He puts it out to Maynard. Maynard's ninth kick for the outer side of the ground, Marshall. As easy as you like, there's Scott Salisbury. Always does a job. Stringer's in front, that's Alan Stringer. Tries to push the ball out to no avail, and umpire Kinnear will bounce it. Graham Cornes is calling the changes for Glenelg. He did it superbly in the second semi-final. He made seven or eight changes, all of them played off. Of course, that was 2 weeks ago. The hairball forward, not the best. A good hairball from that spot. Warren Phillips. Arnold. Playing it a bit casually, North Adelaide. Very casually indeed. Look, Campbell. Ran it away. Oh, the Riley hairball. Not good. Carey. Quick kick back. Hay. Here's a go now, Riley. You're going to run it out, North Adelaide. Up to half forward. Hard in front. Good mark. Gibbs didn't spoil away properly. Oh, they've got players running berserk over there. Phillips, Jarvan, be careful. He was. Got the handball out. Oh, really missed the run of it. Gibbs gets back. In goes the big chap, Parsons. Gibbs ducked the head. I tell you what, there's a bit of panic on out there. The players have slowed down already. Up goes Tiller. The big thump away. Duthie. Alan Stringer. Now Glenelg will run it back.
Over the half forward line, the Bays will go now. Paul puts out the pass in the pocket, is Marshall. Marshall 40 metres out, acute angle. Puts it up now, looking for Kernahan. Big Kernahan off the pack, it's red there. Well, couldn't get it out, however. And it was Stephen Comic. And the ball goes out of play in the full forward left pocket. Robin Kidney waiting his chance to get into the action. Put a throw in adjacent to behind post. Getting back into the action, that is. He's just come off. Ball forced back towards Riley. Gun, the flying shot at goal. It's going to be well off. A point is recorded. Glenelg 2-6, North Adelaide 5-5.
North Adelaide have certainly shown that first quarter, when they kicked into the breeze, may have tired Glenelg a little. They worked very hard. They had a pretty good quarter, Glenelg, in the first. And now we find North Adelaide running that little bit better. They're everywhere at the moment, and they're treating Glenelg with scant disrespect.
It's quite extraordinary for a side that was beaten by Glenelg 2 weeks ago by 14 points. But there's a lot of football left in this game. That kick is not getting much distance. Redden taps it down. Phillips was initially tripped. He was tripped second time. He gets a free kick now. Play on, says the umpire. Away he goes. Antrimus. He's running through half forward now. Gets the kick. Salisbury came in late. Oh, there's a free kick. I don't agree with that.
I do.
We've got a disagreement up here, I can tell you that. But well, Salisbury come in very late. There may have been an elbow there.
No, he just hit him after the play. He kept running at him. He could have avoided. But it was well taken by Antrimus, though. He wrote it pretty well.
Was it ever? John Brearley has got the chance now. Straight through the centre for North Adelaide. Two goals, Brearley. North Adelaide 6-5, Glenelg 2-6.
So Scotty saw, he got a little bit excited there when he saw the little fella Antrimus was running down the ground with the ball. He didn't do anything untoward in the way he approached the player. It was a good hip and shoulder bump. The rules clearly say after disposal you can't run onto the player and go right on with him after he's got rid of the ball. So North Adelaide getting a luxury goal, and they certainly can do with a couple of luxuries at this point of time, but it's something that Glenelg can't do with, because that lead now upward to almost four goals is certainly standing them in good stead.
6-5 North Adelaide, 2-6 Glenelg. Jarvan can't get the kick away. Ball bottled up. Quickly in there, Simons, Tiller over the top, and the umpire will call for another bounce.
The difference in the play, and there's no doubt in my mind, the ability of North Adelaide to handball at the moment is, and their quickness of handball is leaving Glenelg a little bit flat-footed.
Reflex is too good at the moment. A long handball goes out there now to Brenton Phillips. Half forward on Antrimus, wants the long handball out. Half forward, oh, he's lost his footing. Salisbury, Antrimus wants back up support. He's going to get another free kick. Comes up a little
worse.
Probably sounds a little bit proper. Centre half forward. Let's have a look at the free kick. Salisbury, never one to tackle lightly, hanging on to the hand there, the umpire ruled. Out goes the pass. Parsons on the lead. The big fella late getting there. And a fine defensive mark taken by Glenelg's Wayne Stringer. Stringer at centre half back. Bays under tremendous pressure at the moment. Stringer edges the ball out of defence for Kernahan. Big mark. Stringer wants it. The kick is to the outer side. Marshall against Armfield. Marshall lost his footing. Armfield the rebounder. Running Clara Andrews again. Gee, he's loose centre field. Quickly now Phillips through the half forward line. He puts up a high kick. Pull forward. Parsons and Henwood. Henwood thumps clear. Straight back to Robertson. Robertson half forward line. Gets round on that dangerous left leg. But it was smothered. Bennett good. Tiller can. Open goal. 30 metres out. Fire and goal. North Adelaide doing it on the bit. Tiller's first. North Adelaide 7-5. Glenelg 2-6.
Well, North Glenelg are very conscious up in that forward line of spoiling away. Wayne Henwood, who started as the knock ruckman, has been shifted to full back, and on that occasion when the ball came in, he panicked. And instead of taking the ball as it dropped in short on the body, he let fly a wild swing at the ball. It flew free at North Adelaide. They've run up with the play magnificently, and they're starting to read it off hands much better this quarter, and that's why they're in front.
North coach Mike Nunan, pretty happy. Redden is touching the ball first. Oh, Robertson is holding the ball. Now it's held to him. He was tackled high as well. The umpire may have taken that into account in deciding on that. So North are 7-5, Glenelg are 2-6, and we're past 9 minutes now in the second quarter. The crowd yelled for a free kick, but umpire Laurie Argent hasn't given many free kicks today. He'll have another bounce. Mick Redden and Peter Carey there doing battle. Carey over the top, but running it through Robertson. Kicking off the ground was Marshall. Phillips got back beautifully. He plays both ends, Phillips. Andrew Jarman is losing his feet a little bit out there, but he's still pretty useful as John Riley kicks it up forward. Seabone, gee, there were three up there for Glenelg. One's normally enough. Stringer, Maynard out of defence. Kernahan, Coppin, take your pick. No, no, neither Clark and Market. Jarman can't stand up. Wheelie, he'll change direction if he can. Brings it out to grandstand side to Phillips, and he's got the run of the ball all by himself. The little ant wants it. He's got it. And a free kick. The North supporters going berserk here at the moment as little Antrimus gets another free kick. This will be his seventh kick. He was the player making the play. He wanted it. He puts it up to centre half forward. Carey and Redden, and the man that goes down on his knees and takes the mark is Wayne Henwood.
Henwood from centre half back. Gets a lead from Kernahan. That's where the ball travels. His shadow Wilde is there. Thump clear. Salisbury to Marshall. Two Bay players been on the half forward line, but Marshall, no pressure put on him. Changes tack. Puts out a pass. Garland. Beautifully done, David Marshall. Adam Garland has got the ball 30 metres out right in front. And do you think the Bays ever need a goal? Coach Cornes looking anxious, as he might. He's got a deficit of 29 points. Towards the lake end, wind assisted. Gardon's kick. Umpire motionless goal. His first 3-6 to 0. North Adelaide 7-5.
When David Marshall took that ball on centre wing, it was interesting to note that Tony Simons and Peter Maynard ran on for him, and then he ignored both of them, even though they were some 30 to 40 metres up closer to goal, and then straightened up and kicked the ball to Garton. And after the ball was delivered, Peter Maynard showing distinct emotion there at the fact that the ball hadn't been kicked to him, even though the ball had been kicked advantageously to Garton, who's been a real success story in this finals for Glenelg.
Well, the Bays certainly needed that one. Sanders missed it. Hart didn't. North Adelaide again. It's going to be a Hart left footer. The big chap Parsons, one hand up. Gee, holds ground well. The punch away from Seabone was very useful. Gibbs fires one out to the outer side. Marshall waits behind for the one to come over the top. Phillips, duck the head. The tackle's on. The ball comes out. G Jarman now. Let's see if he can hold his feet this time. Hooks it back beautifully to Brearley. Oh, superbly picked out by Jarman.
Jarman's killing him, Peter.
I agree, Ian. He's so clever, isn't he? Very positive player.
Four kicks, seven handballs.
I think they've all counted too. No, that's Bennett, in fact, not really. Bennett's kick is awful. Down on the full. He hasn't had a big part in the game, Peter Bennett, up to this date. His form in the latter half of the season, not that good, but he's playing in a tough spot. Redden gets back, the big chap. No mark. Comes over the top. Chance now. Robertson. Beautifully done. Oh, great start. Redden, Hart, and
a bit far out though, aren't they, Pete, do you think?
He might be. He's nearly averaged three a match this year. He can put a bit of power into that kick. He's put it up, it's coming, but it's just offline. North Adelaide 7-6, Glenelg 3-6.
See, the Bays showing signs of just a little panic. North Adelaide in control at the moment. A lead of 24 points. Doothy's kicking is towards Carey, the big fellow in front, not paid the mark. A bounced out, half forward line. On the attacking corner of the square for North Adelaide. Carey against Redden. McGuinness can't get out now, buys that holding the ball. Didn't have a lot of chance. Free kick is going to Phillips. Centre half forward, Parsons in the square, off he goes now. Big fellow going out to meet the ball. It's beautifully put. Got his hands to it. Couldn't complete it. And Gibbs returns the ball centre field. Stringer under pressure. Maynard. Oh, lost it. Matthew Campbell puts out a pass. Salisbury couldn't quite get there. Missed the ball himself. Gibbs. The lead to the outer side. FAD. The free kick will go to Stephen Copping. Check side centre wing on the outer side.
A little bit silly. North and Glenelg have only met at Football Park on seven occasions since the stadium opened. Glenelg have won every encounter. Kernahan up high. Couldn't hold the mark. There's a free kick for holding on. And that will go to Stephen Riley.
Glenelg have got a chance to get back in. It's only four goals of difference, Pete. We've only played about 15 minutes into the quarter. And they only just have to get a bit of a run on to hold by half-time. But they can't afford to be too far behind.
Stephen Cummings dropped right back. I wouldn't imagine that he would have been instructed to play defensively. Well, he's staying there. He may be on centre wing. Kernahan now at centre half ball. Thought about the handball. Then asked for the 15-metre, and the umpire said no way. Garton's on a lead. Marshall. The thump away comes from Armfield. Garton again. Oh, he's got pace. Comes around beautifully, Garton. Great goal from the big chap. That's his second. Glenelg 4-6, North Adelaide 7-6.
So Adam Garton has kicked the third and fourth goal for Glenelg, and they've both been during this quarter after North Adelaide opened up with the first four goals for the quarter. And Garton, who's been a real success story since he's taken over from Big Steve Thompson from Darwin at the full forward position for the final round. And Adam Garton, great movement, great ability then to turn the corner, and of course, most importantly, to kick the goal.
North Adelaide by 18 points. Carey against Redden. Line ball that one. McGuinness got hit on the head. Kernahan gets it out towards Stringer. Well shepherded by Maynard. Stringer's got to change his direction. Back to Copping, conceding ground. Beats one on the handball away, not good. Riley against Stringer. North Adelaide go away again. This time through Sanders, the high kick to the half forward line. Gibbs getting back. Oh, what a tremendous game this fellow's playing. 10th kick coming up. Edgeworth's in it again, averaging 22 disposals for the season. Not bad for that pocket crowd. Do you think he's playing well now?
15 metres for that little altercation there as Ross Gibbs uses a torpedo punt, looking for Kernahan again. Robertson off hands, going to run it out to Phillips. He's a very clever player. Didn't really have a straight man to kick to then, really. Off hands. Also, David Kernahan, he's just caught on the kick and he's kicked it out on the full. No, just stand it out of bounds.
Peter, makes a difference, doesn't it, when you've got a player in that forward pocket who's capable of chasing like Brearley is that pace, and that's a great view of Football Park in Adelaide. What a great arena it is.
Carey and Redden. at centre wing. Oh, there's a great tackle. Back to Robertson now. He floats one forward. Really under the ball. The punch comes. The run is with Campbell. Campbell puts the ball high. Now passes again. Under the ball. Can't mark it. Andrews. Can't find his feet. He's got his feet now, though. Off he goes. Under the left boot. Oh, short. A grubber. Hart. He's into an open space. Hooks it around now. Tiller's in the pocket. Also Parsons. Offhands, the big chap did it well. His tackle. Close to the line, and there'll be a throw in.
They're going to bounce it, Pete. That's interesting. Ross Gibbs let Tony Angelus run up the ground, then other pose from that back pocket. He's not injured, just stood back in the goal square in the hope that he'd kick it to him.
Parsons gets the tap down towards Sanders. Can't get through. Big fellow Parsons. The kick away is not good. Stringer does it a little better to his brother. Big leap. More gymnastic than effective. Didn't make it. Out goes Kernahan. Campbell back on the ball again. He'll need support. Drop the footy. McGuinness comes out with the ball. The handball. Stringer's not good. He gets blown down. And he'll get the free kick for pushing the back.
I think that's
I think that's
an indication why Glenelg aren't winning either. He wasn't prepared to do anything, then he just fell forward and gave up.
Stringer's kick to the half forward line, finds Jarman. High tackle as well. They elect the play off. Stephen Riley over centre line. A long kick to the half forward line. McGuinness is hurt, looking very proppy. Stringer to Salisbury. Carey got a bad bounce. Oh, high tackle on Riley. And a free kick for going to that player.
Well, it's on up forward as well. McGuinness is hurt. Doesn't look too flash. Wayne Stringer wanted Antrobus's blood then. Ran straight for him. Stephen Riley puts the high ball in. Parsons from behind. Can't take the mark. Oh, Tiller ran straight into the brick wall. Henwood will come out, or will he? He does it beautifully. The steam train. McGuinness, he's hurt. No, he played on. Simons, he's down. Tripped. Stand the mark. David Kernahan off, Robert Kidney on. Kidney wants the ball. Left foot by Simons. He's hurt as well. Gee, there's a few players that are nursing them at the moment. Kidney went through. So did Hart. Hart hasn't got a lot of pace, but he got away from them. Down Bennett.
It's interesting seeing David Kernahan come off because he had a bad shoulder 2 weeks ago and they played him. Maybe he wasn't as fit as he said he was.
Really makes yards. Goes for the thump, which was intelligent. And there'll be a throw in right half forward flank. Tell you what, there are a lot of tired players out there, even at this point of the match. They put in plenty. Glenelg had 14 days to recover from the preliminary final. Before that, late six from last week. Great tackle. Andrews again. He was tackled, didn't have it. Salisbury through, and that's a brilliant tackle, which brings the big chap to a stop. Laurie Argent will bounce the ball, right half forward flank for North Adelaide. The red and whites are going to the southern end, Glenelg to the lake end. Carey, a backhander, Sanders, Bennett. He ducked his head and got the free kick. Well, that's what they say shouldn't happen, but it does. Gibbs was pushed to the back and it's his free kick.
Ross Gibbs picking up kick number 12 plus 15 metres. 21 minutes gone in the second quarter. The 85 grand final. North Adelaide by 18 points and doing it pretty well at the moment. Could be another 15. Not good football by Hart. That's going to bring Gibbs now into the big centre square. Gibbs plays on. Relieving kick going to the half forward line. Kernahan got his hands to it. Couldn't complete it. Quickly now Riley. Getting back on the ball on the left leg, puts it out for Phillips at centre wing, and that's where the ball will end.
He played a great game so far, that Hay, Ian.
Played well. Phillips towards the half forward line. Robinson up high. Quickly now Sanders. Tiller back to Sanders in the double play. Here's a chance now. Robinson, watch him go over the half forward line. Oh, left the footy behind. Oh, who needs the footy? Big Bennett. Robertson. Oh, he's made a mess of this. He's down in trouble again. Tuttle balls it out. But it was straight back to Luthi. Seabone. The double play. Back to Luthi. Now Maynard. And he puts it up for McGuinness centre field.
He's recovered from that injury, McGuinness. Here's a go. Tony Hall's under the ball. He's got it at left half forward flank. Gee, North Adelaide had the chance, but it's going straight back the other end. Maynard plays on, straight through the centre. First goal to Maynard with his 11th kick.
And North Adelaide, in fact, have made a bad error up in that forward line. Not so much that David Robertson left the ball behind, but when he recovered it back and got onto the bottom of the pack, instead of playing safe and perhaps hitting it towards the line, keeping it up to his end of the ground, he just tapped it back in towards the centre-half back area, from which Glenelg were able to rebound the ball straight up the ground. And Peter Maynard's kicked the goal. He was a little bit late getting it to boot, but he finally did, and they've got a well-earned goal. There's only two goals the difference, and there's not much in it just before half-time.
Carey gets the tap down again. Kidney through, the Bays into attack again. Starting to make a strong comeback. Hall gets the tap down towards McGuinness. Riding through, did it well. Trying to get rid of the ball. Hay in the action again. The umpire said, play on. Brilliant tackle put on. Riding, and the free kick will go to Peter Maynard. The kicker of the last goal. No, it's going to Marshall. And Marshall is 45 metres out. Wind assisted. As I said in the first quarter after he missed the centre, one of the best kicks in South Australia. The agony of coaching. David Marshall, 182 senior games, towards the lake end. Nice looking drop, punt, going to struggle for distance. Right on the line, it could be touched, good end! Oh, what a goal! It could be, that is, what a mark! Big pack in the square. Let's have a look at it again. How did he ever mark that? Surrounded by North Adelaide defenders. The mark for which he is renowned. Being put round on an angle. But will be able to better that slightly if need be. He's only 2 metres out. Shouldn't miss. 65 goals for the season to date. That makes it 66 in the Bays fight back. Well, 6-6. North Adelaide 7-6.
So Glenelg kicked the last four goals when in fact they were trailing is the word, by 5 goals, 7 goals to 2. North Adelaide looked as though they were really running on with the game. They've made a couple of careless errors up in the forward line. Glenelg have gained their balance and now they look as though they're going to come right into half-time with nothing in this game. North Adelaide with a breeze in the third quarter. They would have liked to have started the quarter, of course, 2 or 3 goals up, but it doesn't look as though that's going to be the case.
Bays again from the centre. Alan Stringer now coming into the game, puts it up for Stephen Kernahan. He's under the ball. Big mark back there by Stephen Riley. He's taken a few marks. He's had 12 kicks, 6 marks. Good effort. Andrebus, up he goes. Not the best of leaps. Pushing the back there, and a free kick to Salisbury, I think it is. Glenelg on the outer side. Scott Salisbury came onto the ground about 10 minutes back. Garton is leading. Spoil. Kernahan taking another one. Coach Kernan under pressure. Big Stephen Kernahan, a superb judgment of a mark, and he's got the chance to level the scores as we enter time on in this second quarter. The buzz around the stadium at the moment. Glenelg is caught back, trailing at 1 point by 5 goals. The Kernahan kick is straight through the centre. 2 goals, Kernahan. The score's a level, 7-6 apiece.
Well, did North Adelaide sort of sit back on their laurels a little bit when they hit the lead? Well, if they did, Kernahan's going to make sure that he buries it. What a magnificent mark by the young veteran from Glenelg, flying up in the middle of a pack, hands everywhere. You just can't afford to let him get a kick, and he's taking 11 and 12 marks every week, and when he gets him close to the goal, he's real dangerous.
Even Stephen in the grand final, 48 points apiece. Maynard trying to get the ball out. The umpire's going to give him a free kick, or is it Maynard when he comes up for air? Let's have a look who it will be. Yes, Peter Maynard it is, plus 15 metres. Off goes Garton, but he's going in long. Hall, Kernahan at the back of the pack, the big fella up again. Can't get this one. A snapshot away, Copper, got it, he's got it! Oh, what a magnificent goal! The Bays have hit the front. Second goal, Copping. The Bays 8-6, the Northern.
Well, that's what Glenelg want. They want value from Stephen Coffey. He hasn't had a lot of kicks in this final round, but the most important thing in that forward pocket, of course, is to score goals when you get the opportunity, and that was almost an impossible goal, and they're the sort of goals that win finals. Glenelg, six straight goals to take the lead by one.
Well, Adelaide will have to get their act together, even in the last few minutes of this quarter. Is Glenelg running out yet again? They're running right. McGinnis now at half forward. He won't stop still. He did a pirouette then for no real reason. Kicks it into the pocket. Coffey! Great mark. Over the top of John Riley. Stephen Coffey now has got the chance to boot his third goal. He's averaged over three goals a match this year. Prolific goal kicker, Stephen Coffey. The breeze coming from right to left. Kicked it. Three goals, Coffey. Glenelg blitzing North Adelaide now. 9-6 to North Adelaide, 7-6.
And what North Adelaide didn't want to happen was a late quarter revival. I remember we mentioned halfway through the quarter, Glenelg still had an opportunity, and they did take advantage of that opportunity when it came with the breeze. And Stephen Coffey, with two magnificent goals in the last few moments of this quarter, sees North Glenelg go to a two-goal lead. They led at the four-minute mark of the first quarter and have taken over again at the 27 of the second.
A good bounce. Redden against Carey. Sanders. Phillips lost it. Out towards Kidney. Now Phillips running support. Antipas can't pick it up. The umpire centre pushing the back. And the North Adelaide Rover will put them into attack. They need a steady up. Close to half time. Played well this quarter, Antipas. But he's lost his momentum, as North Adelaide has. In the latter part, 10th kick. Not a good one. And floats towards Kidney on the half back line. Kidney goes for Kernahan, pushing and shoving at the back. Simons whips out the handball. What a good run. Maynard couldn't. Try to get it across to McGinnis. And out comes Roberts, and he's caught. Wilby to Redden. Supported through Stephen Riley. Lost his footing. And now Brandon Phillips. The running power is Sanders. For the kicker shocker. Up towards Parsons. Here's a chance. Bennett back. Andrew Jarman. Point blank range. Shoots. And missed. Oh, what an important shot for North Adelaide. Confidence down. The Bays making a big run. And not a hard shot at goal. Nudge their 7th point. 7-7 to 9-6.
Back it comes. Hart. McDermott. McDermott takes the easy mark. Well, North Adelaide went forward. Jarman missed. That's how footy goes. Kernahan now and Wieldy. Wieldy did it well. Kernahan took it off him though. Another chance for the Bays now. Here's a go for McGinnis. He's got it at centre half forward. He thought about taking off. He does now. The kick goes right in, but he's offline also. Perhaps he should have taken his time. Glenelg 9-7, North Adelaide 7-7.
1-3 to Tony McGinnis.
Looseness creeping into the North Adelaide defence. Could be their running class not going down. Hayes going to boot the ball back into play after his little sortie. Rise for passing. There isn't Arnold out there, Arnold. Arnold on the half back line at the moment. He's come out from defence. Siren sounds. The big quarter for the Bays. They struggled early, but they have turned a 7 direction, an 11 point deficit at quarter time into a 12 point game at half time. At half time in the big one here at Football Park, Glenelg 9-7, lead North Adelaide 7-7.
To win the game. It's a tight game, but you must favour the Bays from this position.
Okay, there's just one half of football remaining for season 1985. One of these two sides will come away with a premiership flag. For their call of the third quarter, it's back to Ian Day, Peter Marker and Robert Ovie.
The second half of the 1985 Grand Final, Glenelg by 12 points, a turnaround of 23 points in that second quarter. Carey thumps the big one towards the half forward line. Kernahan back now towards Simons. McDermott wants it out cleverly. McGinnis 30 metres out onto the left flank, shoots the goal in the base for a tremendous start. McGinnis puts his second goal. It took exactly 21 seconds. The Bays 10-7, North Adelaide 7-7.
And Peter Carey up in the air and smashing. pushing the ball forward. Glenelg getting to the ball best and up in that half forward line. McInnes, North defence, caught up the ground. McInnes on his own and then into the goal. That is an important goal. That stretches the lead to three and they're kicking into a pretty stiff breeze. North are really going to have to find something.
Peter Carey has given the Bays a pretty big lift. Andrews let the ball go. Ducking the head there was Stringer. Kidney goes through. Handball is astray. Jarman gets caught but gets away beautifully. Now Matthew Campbell with a run of it. Andrews might get it next or Campbell might run all the way. Puts one right up into the square. Up they go and it's off hands. Through for a point. Thought he may have run that one onto Andrews then just to get them a little bit closer to the goal, but he didn't. All that lead now 7-8 to Glenelg 10-7.
Pace of plenty. Gibbs. The outer side, Kernahan. Under the left leg of Antrobus, up towards full forward. Gibbs thumps the ball clear again, and it goes out of play about 35 metres around. 10-7 Glenelg, 7-8 North Adelaide. Carey and Redden at the throw-in. Redden cleverly to Hart, the running player, Jarman shoots for goal, and he's just offline. Fine attempt, but a most acute angle. 1 point only North Adelaide, 7-9, Glenelg 10-7.
Very, very hard to score a goal from that spot. Most players generally centre the ball. Now Henwood, who's got the job at fullback, he went there quite early in the game. Big leap out there, but no mark to the Glenelg player. Hart again. Antrobus went straight over his head. Maynard intercepts, dropped the ball, got it back again. McDermott to Stringer, back to McDermott, he's going to get collared, holding the ball. It was a good movement by North Adelaide, they anticipated his run and cut him off. Now Sanders. Sanders the ball to centre half four, the whistle is gone, he'll get a slight advantage, another 15 metres. Well, North Adelaide at the midway mark of the second quarter, had everything going for it. Robertson was running along the left forward pocket area, had two bounces and then suddenly he didn't have the ball anymore. The recovery wasn't there, it went back to Maynard, he scored and then Glenelg piled on seven without a miss. That could be the game this year. Parsons, Carey over the top, running it on open goal is Hart. Beautifully anticipated, not good defence by the Bays, his first goal. North Adelaide 8-9, Glenelg 10-7.
Ball coming off hands then. Glenelg defenders paying a lot of attention to big Mike Parsons. There was three of them up there. Peter Carey, Wayne Henwood, all up in the area having a go at Parsons. It came to ground. And the North Adelaide players are down there scouting the packs. They've always got an opportunity while there's so many players in the air. Big Parsons is a constant threat to them up in that full court area. But North are going to get a bit of lift from the centre square. And big Mick Redden's got to find a little.
Yes, they've got them. Play bottled up in the centre circle. The umpire coming in to repeat the bounce. North Adelaide kicking with the breeze for the last time. At least this season. Carey got the tap away. Andrews conceding ground back in defence. Joined by Campbell. Couldn't pick up the footy. Phillips over the top there of Kidney. And the umpire will come in and rebound the football. Marginally in the Bay's attacking area. They're up by 10 points. Having been up by 12 at the start of the quarter. Carey had a roundhouse right to fist. Tiller got it out towards Antrobus. He can't pick it up. Beautifully stolen there by McDermott. Shoots for goal, but he's going to be well offline. Well done, Chris McDermott. Couldn't quite make the grade. 10-8 Glenelg, 8-9 North Adelaide.
Tony Antrobus panicking a little bit every time he gets near the ball. They got stuck into him in the first half, and well, they might, because he's a very dangerous player. They've got to be with him, but he mustn't lose his cool in close quarters.
Off hands it comes towards Matthew Campbell. He's got no one to grip the ball to. Kicks it high and wide. Bennett, Seabone smashes away and there'll be a throw in right half forward flank for North Adelaide. His Antrobus has quite often got to the ball and tried to play it around his feet and occasionally he's fallen over with it. The North Adelaide, the Glenelg players have woken up to that. Bennett. McDermott couldn't get the handball out. Play will be blocked again in that half forward right area. So we'll see another bounce.
Yeah, it looks about a little out of place, Antrobus, doesn't he, when he misses that handball. And there again, West Lakes.
Off hands, Bennett. Maynard in very hard. Very congested play out there. And we'll see another bounce. conditions extremely good. I think that breeze is stronger this quarter than it was early. North Adelaide will have to take immediate advantage. 5.5 minutes now into the third quarter. Anthem is playing for it again. Take it cleanly. He wants a free kick, but umpire Kinnear will bounce it.
Untidy play at the moment as both teams struggle for supremacy. Carey using his body against Redden, got it towards Antrobus, and he's going to get a free kick for pushing the back. The umpire sorting it out a little bit. Down he goes. I would think that's 15 metres. Brings him about 50 metres out. Can't make the distance. Puts out the pass. Going to be easily cut off by Marshall. Marshall in turn to Doofy. Phillips making a metre to get there. Out in front of Simon. Centre wing. Simon's turns well. Off goes Garten. Beautifully put, Tony Simon. Oops! Nearly dropped it. Kidney wants it. Wobbles one towards that player. Out comes Kernahan. Kernahan 30 metres out. Gets round. And shoots. That looks home. Oh, what a goal, Stephen Kernahan. His third. The Bays 11-8. North Adelaide 8-9.
Well, it's all in the balance of the player. That's what a champion's all about. He runs to the ball, he takes the ball cleanly, he walks around, and he makes it look an absolute piece of cake, so to put it. And Stephen Kernahan, all balanced, body at the ball, no snatch with the hands, just straight through with the body, round he went, always under control. And that's a great goal for Glenelg. So they're still just under 3 goals in front, 17 points in back, and doing it very well.
Jarman's at half forward now, Sanders in the middle. Jarman for the tackle. Wayne Stringer. Glenelg now starting to take control of the game as Hay and Hall do battle. Doothy is on centre wing for Glenelg. Jarman's gone to half forward for North Adelaide. Sanders in the middle. Thought he may have used Campbell there, but he's elected not to. Kernahan sweeps it wide towards McDermott. Kick off the ground there by a North Adelaide player. The umpire says play on. Look to be high. Got a couple go of late.
Well, particularly that player, number 25, Alan Stringer, he's fallen over every time he's been in front line for the ball.
Kidney, a lot of pace. Hart, Hay couldn't take the mark. There's a free kick. Holding on against Tony Hall. No, it's an FAD, in fact. Three after disposal. Tony Hall's got it at left half forward flank. No two guesses there. He's aiming for Kernahan up high. Up hands, got him! He's kicked another one. His third. Glenelg have got a stranglehold now. 12-8 to North Adelaide 8-9.
It's a great third quarter by Glenelg in the first 8 minutes, kicking 3 goals. And of course that one to Adam Garten, the big fellow, 6'4", 6'5" tall. The full quarter, when that ball was thrown away, oh how cleanly he took it. That was a wonderful take by the big fellow, you know, hitting right in the tummy. And he's converted a well-balanced goal, and he's proving himself to be a very fine player in this final series. Michael Noonan, the North Adelaide coach, he's certainly got a few frowns.
Well, he's got a problem or two at the moment, kicking with the breeze. He's actually going backwards. Brandon Phillips, beautifully out of trouble. Whips out the long handball, Campbell. He'll have to give it back to Phillips. Not a good one, had to half volley it. The Bays butler up, and umpire Kinnear in for the bounce. The umpire's doing a fine job in the grand final. 12-8 to 8-9. North desperately needing goals. Campbell kicked to the half forward line. Simo couldn't find it at first. Got it back to Salisbury and turned Gibbs. There was a free. The umpire paid to advantage. Marshall half back line. The Bays playing with composure. Finds Tony Simons at centre wing. Simons looking for the lead. Kernahan goes into the pocket. That's the way the ball will go. Wildy with him. Thumps the ball clear again and out of play. They throw in on the half-forward right flank. Bays attacking into the breeze and have eked out their lead from 12 to 23 points. 10 minutes gone of the second half. Kernahan hooks it back, looking for a fleet-footed player. Maynard is there. Can't keep his footing. Taps it out. Sanders. Now Hart. And the umpire will bounce.
North Adelaide will have to be careful, otherwise Glenelg will run right. 8-9 North, Glenelg 12-8. We're 10 minutes into the third quarter. Kernahan in ruck, pushes it down to Maynard. The quick kick away, sees Riley in front. Copping in late, off hands, copping. Holding the man, says some part. Murray Argent. I guess the question is, they're copying habit.
You see it on the telly now, Pete. He had him a bit early.
Perhaps it was a play-on call. Stephen Copping from right half forward. 45 degree angle only, and he'd be 35 metres out. The breeze is against him, but it may not bother him. Now he's pushed it across to the left. So it's 1 point. Glenelg 12-9, North Adelaide 8-9.
Arnold to kick the ball back into play. Gets a lead from Campbell on the outer side. And ran it on grandstand side, also Riley. And that's where it finishes. John Riley in the back pocket. To Wilde. North Adelaide edging the ball out of defence. But they need goals. They need them quickly. A deficit of 24 points. Oh, not a good one, that one. Although Stephen Riley got up high to take the mark. Three kicks have got them about 70 metres. Plus 15 now. Riley from the half-back line centres the ball to the half-forward line. Carey comes in, takes the easy defensive mark. Gee, the Bay's looking good at the moment. Kernahan out wide. If Carey can get it out to him, Carey concedes back to Seabone. Now it will go to Stephen Kernahan. Running far in McGuinness. Wayne Stringer. Now McGuinness. The Bay's running. Kidney. McGuinness, one to beat, can't get round, all busted the tackle, now he's left. Oh, gee, he was in more strife than Brick Bradford, got out of it, got the free kick, about 45 metres out. Another metre and he would have shrugged it off and got clear. Desperate defence by North Adelaide, tangoed once, tried to do it the second time, there went the legging, and a free kick number 8. Tony McGuinness, 45 metres out. Or the kick is a shocker, dropping short, socket away. And the ball is taken by Campbell, who claims the mark. Now Riley.
Riley running out of halfback. He has to chip it high because he had no one long. And now Andrew Jarman. Was he off? I think he was. Jarman, McGuinness. Push under the chin there, can sometimes lose you the ball.
I think if you put on a big enough act.
Jarman. Paying that to Maynard. Didn't have a great deal of it. He seems to have hurt his wrist. He certainly had the ball a lot, Maynard. That's his 15th kick, in fact. He's gone to centre half forward. Kernahan will hit that. I'm not sure what David Wilde was trying to do there, but it didn't look too flash.
I think he's a bit frustrated. I think Kernahan's got on top of him.
Well, it missed the first time, and I've got a feeling that he came up with two others that were a bit silly. Certainly very frustrated, but it doesn't entitle you to go punch drunk. Marsh was on his own, by the way, and Kernahan doesn't need it. He'll kick a goal from there.
It's the longest 15 metres you've ever seen.
There's a couple of changes too, Peter, in the side. I noticed John Brearley coming back into defence, and Travis has been put up into the forward pocket, into the right up in the pocket, just resting up there on Ross Gibbs. Vic Brearley coming down onto the ball, maybe into full back.
Kernahan in control at centre half forward now. I think that sign says it all as Kernahan lines up and splits the centre. Four goals, Kernahan. Glenelg 13-9, North Adelaide 8-9.
David Wilde coming from behind then, the ball holding up in the breeze, and Stephen Kernahan going forward and taking a well-judged mark. And then coming in a little bit late, David Wilde just hit him over the left-hand ear and then went on with the act a couple afterwards, and that cost him about 30 metres and put Glenelg right in front of goal. And Stephen Kernahan increases the lead to 5 goals, and so Glenelg on their way to the 1985 Grand Final.
Simons against the tide, whips out the handball. Another free kick to the Bays. North Adelaide becoming a little frustrated. Simons still in the big centre square. Off goes Garton. Doesn't want that player. He's going to put it up in the air for Kernahan. Smothered, however. Darryl Hart back in defence. Arm through the cross, correction. Towards centre wing. Trying to make a metre to get there with Salisbury. But the ball comes out of play. to throw in at centre wing. Glenelg by 30 points and kicking into the breeze in this third quarter. Carey used his strength to get it back towards Kidney. Kidney the high tackle, and once again the Bays will go into attack.
Yeah, it's interesting. They were 5 goals down at the 8-minute mark of the second quarter. Glenelg at the 14-minute of the third, they're 5 up.
A big turnaround. Kernahan just gave him one back. And he gave a big one back too. Well, it's on now.
Here's the Stouse.
The players want to get involved. I tell you what, David Wheelie is still on the ground. He's not quite sure what day it is. The umpires are getting in there now. Wheelie is still down. And Kernahan didn't like what he got, so he gave him one straight back. I'm not quite sure here that two wrongs make a right, but
he certainly did it in the right time, though, when the ball was right there. Who's the umpire to say that he wasn't going for the ball?
Was it Kernahan? Let's have a look at it again in replay. Up goes Wildey. You might say that that was a left cross. And Kernahan could have been easily trying to fish the ball away.
It's a stretcher here.
Tell that to Wildey now. He's out.
And he's got a big cherry right over the left eye. You can see it there on screen.
He is motionless. Cannot scratch himself. Out comes the stretcher. Bad luck for North Adelaide. They're going to have to recast. Although at this stage, Kernahan was definitely on top of Wildey after a fine first quarter. Coach Michael Noonan, likewise Graham Studley Cornes, as he's known in South Australia. Just seeing what moves that North coach Noonan will come up with.
Ian, I think in a lot of circumstances you could probably feel sorry for a guy that is on the end of one of those and that gets laid on a stretcher, but I guess the camera told the story 3 or 4 minutes later. Perhaps he just got back what he gave.
Yes, we'll tell that to the player who stretched it off the arena, David Wildey. Now North Adelaide are going to bring Trevor Hill into the game. Well, Hill is a wingman come half-forward player. Who will Coach Noonan put on Stephen Kernahan? Let's have a look at the replay. Now, you could say that he was trying to thump the ball clear.
I think he's a better judge than that, Ian. He knows where the ball is.
I'm being nice. A fine sportsman. As I said, tell that to David Wildey, but the free kick will go to John Riley. Now, who will go on to Stephen Kernahan as Wildey, motionless, is stretched down into the room?
I think some time ago, actually, John Riley was shifted with Brearley going into defence. Noonan was in the process of making that change a moment ago.
Players going out like nine pins, a push out, and it's Seabone, the free kick.
He plays it on now to Salisbury. He's got players to give it to, plenty of them. But he runs it out. Ball ran out.
Stephen Hay on to Kernahan.
Kip Clump on the bench, and he just tackled in with Simons. So not even the players on the ground, it's everyone at the moment. Carey pushes it through. That was not a free kick.
He's had a push from the back, he's hit from the front.
He was hit from the front across the chest area, and umpire Laurie Argent was completely fooled by that. It's a bad guess, Laurie. McDermott puts it up to centre half forward. Kernahan and Hay. But the good mark is taken by John Brearley in front. Oh, dear, oh dear, Phillips. The handball, untidy. Through goes John Riley. Got out of it. Oh, Arnold's handball to the little player. Tony Hall to McDermott. Maynard, he's put down. It. Buccaneers saw it. Up they go. They've spoiled each other, two the little players. Armfield runs away with the ball. There's trainers running all over the ground. Total confusion here at Football Park at the moment. Another one goes down. Garton. They've jumped up. They won't let him go. In goes Kidney. Meanwhile, the play's still on. Campbell runs through half-back. He picks it up. Parsons is going to get caught. Too far behind. The fight's still on. Seabone puts it out wide. And Campbell's marked it. Well, there it is. They're not in love, those two players, I can tell you. Plenty happened. And there's another fight on right up at the other end of the ground. The boundary umpires don't know what to do.
That's an interesting pose, Peter.
They're not in love either, Ian.
Salisbury and Antrobus, he'd be in it. As I said, he loves a scrap rather than a feed.
Two North have lost the ball here. They had it. They gave it away.
They kicked it out of bounds on the full. The North Adelaide player, Matthew Campbell, is attempting to play to the player. Kicked it out on the full, and now he's been awarded a 15 metres against him.
Robertson's just put a Glenelg trainer down in the centre of the ground. And he touched him 30 metres and put him down.
Gee, what a game of footy. I suppose you could call it football. Armfield to Hill in the action quickly. Now Sanders with a chance. North Adelaide into attack and badly needing a goal. Parsons hardly sighted since the first quarter as the ball sucked clear. Wayne Stringer. Marshall. Seabone. Well, Henwood left the ball behind. Now he has time to recover as he fires the ball out of defence towards Simon. Phillips lost the footy. Simon's under pressure, going through his arm field. Good tackle, McDermott. Kidney in. They better up again now. Five seen a free kick, and it's going the way of the Bay.
He saw the free kick for around the neck. I'm not sure that was on, but the punch to the head was definitely a free kick.
There's more fights than kicks at the moment, Robert. The grand final getting out of hand, but the Bays can smile at the moment. They've got a lead of 30 points. And knowing full well coming home with a breeze, the concerned face of Michael Lunan. Marshall almost half volley, lost it to Phillips, and the ball tumbles out of play.
Well, Glenelg really only had to keep their cool, and they've got the game because North Adelaide have lost a key defender. Parsons cannot get into the act at all. Who was holding on to who then? Tiller, but it's McGuinness. Jarman put him down. Down goes Maynard, but he was going to get it anyway. Tell you what, there'll be...
If Maynard was
plenty of headache tablets after this game. The umpire let Stringer play that ball on, and it wasn't his ball. Kernahan took a screamer at centre-half forward. But the umpire made a mistake in the centre of the ground.
No, he's allowed to let the player have the free kick here if the other bloke can't kick it.
No.
No, he'd rather. He's out of action, you see.
You might with that with the odd camera, Robert. Kernahan's got it at centre-half forward. Nine marks, Kernahan. He's at centre-half forward now. He's kicked four goals. He's given that one a big chance. It's through. 5 goals, Kernahan. Cornes 14-9, North Adelaide 8-9.
And they're continuing to play the ball well. They haven't lost their cool altogether. They're prepared to fight. Adam Gartner ran up the ground some 50 metres ago, a moment ago, to get into the act from full forward. He's certainly revved up. And when they're getting on with the ball, Glenelg, they're going right on with the job. And that was another great goal to Stephen Kernahan. After an advantage free in the centre, Glenelg player showing a little bit of nous and getting it on quickly. And Glenelg taking advantage of everything that's going for them at the moment. And they're playing in great form.
14-9 plays 8-9. Murphy about to come on for the Bays. Going like winners at the moment. A repeat bounce at the centre. Carey again playing well in the ruck out in front of Kidney. Hart right there with him. Kidney tackle. Lost the footy. They still can't get him out. By set play on. In there goes McDermott. The player stack up. And the umpire will come in and bounce. Michael Farquhar on the boundary.
David Woody at the moment doesn't quite know where he is down in the change rooms. There's a chance to come back on a bit later in the game. Perhaps depends on the situation.
Thank you, Michael. McDermott. Up towards full forward. Salisbury. Tiller. Salisbury and Tiller. Down goes Salisbury and the umpire in for the bounce. 14-9, plays 8-9. Plenty for the crowd to yell about in this quarter. Bennett up very early, down to Hart. A high kick out of defence. Stringer sets himself. All taken beautifully by Phillips. He's made a space. Bobs off, drives a long one to the half forward line. Jarman's up there. This way, that away. Back on the left leg. Shoots for goal. Good keeper. Oh, hit the woodwork. Well, Jarman's playing in the forward pocket. North can't take the trick. They can't win the game or the fights.
8-10 plays 14-9. Henwood will boot out. Kidney coming off. Murphy on. Or is it Maynard? Maynard it is. He was the one that appeared to be winded in the centre of the ground a little while ago. Played a very good game though. Short. Hart's called for it again. Only put one hand up when he got there. He's running it through the forward pocket area. Gee, they forgot to tackle him. He's kicked it with the left foot. He's kicked a goal. 2 goals, Hart. 4-9-10, Glenelg 14-9.
Well, the Glenelg defence that you were tired then, when Darryl Hart got his hands on that ball, he just followed it through, fell over, got up again, then went on with the job. and the player's unable to recover. Both McGuinness and Seabone nowhere near the player, and that's a good goal by Hardy. Opened up the goal front for himself by running out towards the 10 metre square. North Adelaide need more, running 19 shots to 23, and Glenelg holding a sound advantage.
Phillips sends North Adelaide into attack again up towards the half forward line. Here's a chance. Bennett got it back to Sanders, hook round the corner. All the way back there as Henwood takes the easy chest mark. Flips out a pass. Beautifully done to Marshall. Tangos. Drive to the half forward line. Looking again for Kernahan underneath the footy. Beautiful handball haul. Tony Simons, Garland wants it. That's the way the ball's going. Couldn't get his hands to it. Arnold. Copping can't catch him as Arnold defends to the outer side. The match in two out there. Campbell against Kidney. Into the scene comes Arnold. Kidney with the ball underneath him. And the umpire will come in and bounce.
A little bit lucky. Northern 9-10. Glenelg 14-9. We're in time on now this third quarter. And it's been an eventful one. North have kicked five goals. North Adelaide two. And the Roosters have been going with the breeze. So it's been a bad quarter for them. That was a handball to the feet of a player. Copping ran through and got grabbed high. Hall will get it, or try and get it next. Phillips intercepted well. Carey lurking in the centre. Down to Marshall. Marshall will go long. Beautiful kick, Marshall. Off line slightly. Murphy couldn't take the mark. A point of hands. North Adelaide 9-10. Glenelg 14-10.
Well into time on. Bays by 30 points. Stephen Riley defends to the outer side, looking out there for Bennett, who's having a run on the ball. Copping takes it to Kidney. Slipped out the handball. McGuinness all left the footy behind. Riley does it well. Hill and Copping, and the ball comes out of play. Close to three-quarter time in the 85 Grand Final. A top quarter for Glenelg. Kernahan against Brealey. Players getting a little tired, jumping on the ball a lot, and another bounce will take place on the outer side.
Past 27 minutes now, and any score to either side would be very handy, particularly North Adelaide. A couple before the break to put it in touch. Well feinted there by McDermott. McGuinness will have to be careful. Wiley, Hill, North Adelaide now with a break. Matthew Campbell, he is a speedster. Andrews wants it. Campbell shoots it up for the big chap. Parsons, he hasn't been in the game for a long time. It went over the players. Parsons couldn't keep it in. We'll see a throw in the right forward pocket.
Yeah, Henwood's done a pretty good job since going back there. He's certainly competed very well. His ability to jump has been good. Maybe I think Parsons has led a lot more too, Peter. He's tried to lead to receive the ball. Perhaps he would have been a more advantage to North Adelaide if he'd have stood his ground.
I'd agree. Leading's not his game. Parsons puts hand on the ball. Hart again. Kick really didn't have any purpose. Gibbs. Hart. The handball was to McDermott. Unintentionally, of course. Three North Adelaide players. Campbell. He should centre it, but doesn't. Kicks it out on the ball.
Well, North Adelaide certainly not going too well. They kicked one goal, two in the first 3 minutes of this quarter, then they didn't score for 20, and they've got the breeze, and they've kicked 1-1 for a total of 2-3 for the quarter against Glenelg's five goals, three into the breeze.
Been a good move by Coach Cornes to put Henwood back in defence, because he's played well back there, and Parsons and here he's been to play a lot more, and he's playing particularly well. I think that could be out on the full. And the free kick out there will go to Campbell. Too far out to score. Time running out in this quarter for North Adelaide. Sanders very close to the line. Must have been centimetres inside. And he might be too far out as well. Off goes Parsons. Carey comes over the top. Siren sound. Oh, what a top quarter for Glenelg. They put it 5-3 to 2-3 and we're kicking into the breeze. The three-quarter time in the 1985 Grand Final. Glenelg 14-10. The North Adelaide 9-10. The final quarter in readiness. The Bays by 30 points. They led by 12 at half-time, eked it out to 13 to come home with a breeze. Peter Marker.
Yes, a quarter of truth for both sides this year. Glenelg with an enormous advantage, 5 goals up. Redden got his hands to it, Hill over the top. Through goes Salisbury, through comes Hay without the ball. Conceding ground unintentionally on that occasion, Matthew Campbell, he gets it back. They come out though, North Adelaide. Player on the ground is Sutrams. Andrews. Boy, I'd love to hate him. Good mark, Gibbs. He really knows where the ball is, Ross Gibbs. Some say he's loose. Certainly find the ball. 15 kicks for the little back pocket. A prolific kick winner in that position. He gets distance to centre wing. Kernahan is his aim. Can't blame him. They both went down then. The handball missed. Tackle was good, but he had no chance to get rid of it. And umpire Arden will bounce it.
Very well done by McDermott. Then really took that down well indeed.
Kernahan. He put it so hard to Murphy, he couldn't do anything with it. There'll be another bounce.
On the half-forward line, the Bays in attack and leading by 30 points. The 1985 flag firmly in their sights at the moment. You're never dead until you lie down, but North Adelaide are going to have to fight hard from here. Bay throws it out. Robertson back in defence. Gets it to the half-back line to Campbell. Head to the spot. Murphy against the tide, got it well over to Salisbury, screws on that one at the half forward line. Simon, off goes Copping, it's beautifully put to that player. Right there with him is Riley, did well. All into the action now with Stephen Riley, who comes out for the footy. Got no one to kick it to though. To Hill. On the defensive corner of the square. Oh, he lost his footing, he's under pressure, holding the ball. Oh, what bad luck. They play on Simon. Changed direction, lost his footing, lost the footing, and Garrod is now shooting for goal. The big fellow has got 3, he's only 30 metres out. Wind assisted towards the lake end, it's a high kick. It's a straight kick, and the Bays go on them every way. 4 goals, Garrod. 15-10 to now, North Adelaide 9-10. That could be the end of the finish action.
So Adam Garten receiving a ball after another error by North Adelaide, slipping over Trevor Hill, but Garten, how well he moves, like he was a yard behind, or a metre behind, should I say, when the ball came into the goal square. By the time the ball arrived there, he was 3 in front and doing it easily, and that's a great kick too. So cool under pressure, he knows the goals are required, and it was Garten in the second quarter, in fact, that set Glenelg on the path by kicking their 3rd and 4th goals.
Holding the ball decision at the centre of the ground sees Robertson, who has fallen significantly out of this game. He'll boot it to half forward left, looking for Jarman, but he hasn't got the pace to go with Duthie. He's holding on to him. Now Hill picks it up again, shoots it back towards Greeley. No one home. Greeley goes for the smash, missed it completely. Henwood pushes it out. Players dive all over the ball, and the umpire Argent will bounce it 10 metres from the North Adelaide goal. On several occasions in this match, North Adelaide have conceded goals to Glenelg through their own mistakes. Really to do battle. Bennett trying to get it out. Hart turned around the corner and put his 3rd goal. Or was it Sanders? Sanders was the player who got his 2nd. It was amazing work there from Bennett and a good reflex goal from Sanders.
Did I detect a throw in there?
He certainly got that onto his boot quickly, but it's the ability to turn around and get that ball away. And Sanders did that well. Of course, he's a young man who's only played very few games. He's had a bad injury, and he's come into the side. He replaced Trevor Hill on centre wing, and he certainly is a good kick. Usually over distance, but that was very quick reflex.
Carey to McGuinness. A high kick by the left footer. Riley comes to meet it with Copping. Neither can get there. Comes out Kidney. Now Copping. He grabs a kick away, coming to meet it, his arm filled, the long hand ball, not successful, and the ball out of play. 5 minutes gone in the final quarter for 1985. The Bay's looking good. Kernahan, what a performer. Casually takes the ball. McDermott, McGuinness, thought he might change direction, puts it up. Marshall makes a meter to get there. Cutthorpe copping it was. Sock away from that player. Who with a chance will have to get rid of that in a hurry. Tiller is upended. Down goes Salisbury. Marshall, McGuinness, high to the half forward line. Kernahan up high. Can't get it. Copping. Gives it over Siren. Walking goal. Beautifully done. Simon's first. The Bays 16-10 plays North Adelaide 10-10.
Well, they were certainly rallying in the middle of the ground, and Graham Cornes, do I detect there a sign of emotion as he sees a 6-goal lead on the board? And that was a great bit of rallying by the Bays, and a beautiful handball by Copping after Kernahan had just gently laid the ball off. He didn't go for it strongly in case of damage. Well done by Simons running into the goal.
Well, can North Adelaide stay in this game? As I said before, they get blitzed if they drop their heads in any fashion at all. As Stringer puts it forward, Murphy couldn't take the mark. McGuinness with pace. Now Murphy again, very close to the line. Back to McDermott. Murphy again. They've got Elgar in control. That's a huge kick to the square. Big pack of players, and it puts through for a point. North Adelaide 10-10, Glenelg 16-11.
What can the Northerners do now? They're getting run over since about halfway through that second quarter. It's been mostly the Bays. Since Kernahan got on top. Robertson in defence. North Adelaide can't get any momentum going at all. Salisbury, but there's a holding foul against Carey. It'll go to Brenton Phillips. The check side of centre wing to put the Roosters into attack. It's a lead from Bennett on the half forward line. Seabohm is with him. Seabohm up high. Thumps it clear. Through comes Phillips again. Runs into trouble. Lost the footy, holding the ball. Nothing going right for North Adelaide. Then David Marshall, the recipient of the free kick. From the defensive corner of the square. Goes for the lead of Murphy. But Simons. Simons has got it. McDermott running into the free space. But he's going in longer for Garton or Copping. Copping over the top in front, Riley. And the North Adelaide player wins the free kick, hands it off to Arm. Wins the mark, actually.
Robertson. Air traverse it. No, he didn't give it. Again. He hasn't given that first ball today. That's caught him undone.
I don't think he even tackled him then. I think he just cannoned into that bloke, ran off him, and the umpire thought he was going to tackle him, and he didn't quite make it. And so he's copped the 15 metre as well.
He gave the second one back pretty quickly too.
Like a bullet.
Right on the top of his head. So Robin Kidney with a chance to score from left half forward, and North Adelaide are being run over now. Glenelg powering their way to the final in 85, and that's going to fade off just to the point. So Glenelg 16-12, North 10-10, and the official attendance here today, 50,289 people.
Of course, this 38-point lead is the biggest margin all day. No one's been that far in front. Maybe Glenelg can go even further in front of you.
North Adelaide with 29 points in front at one stage in that second quarter, Robert. So it's been a big turnaround by Glenelg. And they've played very well indeed. Obviously, they've got a lead of 38 points as Matthew Campbell edges North Adelaide out of defence. Duke at centre wing on the outer side. Normally plays full back, but they've put the taller Wayne Henwood on passes, if indeed he is playing full forward. But he's certainly hanging around that area. North Adelaide's kick, it'll go to Trevor Hill. A veteran, 29 years of age. Averaging 22 disposals for the season. Got to sit on the fence to start with. McDermott. Gibbs. Well, the Bays in control. David Marshall. The long kick to the half forward line. Kernahan! Oh, what a mark! Number 10. Kernahan at his best. At the set. Oh, what a beautiful mark. Puts it in towards goal. Up they go again. But the ball has hit the post. And a point is recorded. 16-13, Glenelg, 10-10, North Adelaide.
Kernahan totally dominant now on the forward line, running right. Not a great deal the Northerners can do, because the ball is coming down fairly easily, and Coach Noonan, I think, would recognise that. Arnold to grandstand side. Campbell gets front spot. Zuchens. Hill came onto the ground, but Carey, the Bay captain, couldn't quite make it. Sanders will get a free kick for getting whacked after he's disposed of the ball. The Bay captain, Peter Carey's worked pretty well today. I think it's his best final. Played two quarters of very good football. Crowd getting pretty excited in anticipation of a Bay win. Carey hooks it back. Salisbury is put down, holding the ball. That's a good tackle. Tiller thought about playing it on. There's a bit of movement up there now with Bennett running into the pocket. He's gone to full forward. Up he goes. Oh, he missed the link totally. Duthie beautifully puts it out towards Simons. Hill got there too late. Marshall gets around very easily. Disposes of the ball like a gem normally. Gart dropped it. Arnold and John Riley. Riley will in turn try and find Armfield. Gee, I think Simons may have kept it in. He did. Marshall and Copping. Dermot next, deep in the pocket, and he'll have a shot for goal.
Peter, I think Parsons might be on the bench.
He is in. There's a good comeback onto the ground after three-quarter time. And Arnold ran into McDermott there. There was very, very little in it. Nevertheless, McDermott has got a 15-metre penalty, which gives him a big chance for a goal. McDermott has now.
So 17-13 to Glenelg now. McDermott's first goal. Certainly been a hard worker for the Bays over the whole season. He's done a lot of very vigorous work. He's certainly one of their most competitive players. He always starts on the ball for them because they know of his competitive work in the centre of the ground. And Tony McGinnis up in that forward pocket. They've been a quick duo throughout the whole season. McGinnis's pace, of course, coming back onto the ball sort of late in the first quarter has always been a great advantage for Glenelg. But David Wilde now on the bench, a little cut over his eye, not in the best of condition, and he's back just resting where he'll be for the rest of this game.
Looks like the year of the Tiger. The first since 1973. They've been in a few finals, by G. Antrobus, he certainly hasn't chucked it away. The crowd gives him the cheerio. Shoots for goal, coming back with a boot. Oh, what a brilliant goal, Tony Antrobus. But it could be too late. His first, 11-10 North Adelaide, 17-13 for Earl.
Well, that's what Tony Antrobus likes to do, is get the ball and run with it. During the afternoon, he's been caught on several occasions, but he has been able to whip the ball off quickly on close quarters. He's preferred to try to break clear with a little tap around the body, but the Glenelg players have been too close. They've upset that particular play. When he gets clear like that and can kick for goal, he's a very dangerous player, but Glenelg haven't allowed that today.
115 and 76. Brenton still jumping. Tiller away from centre, kicks long. Jarman's a half forward. Duthie, too much height, takes the mark in front. Plays it on. Seabone pretty steady. Carey under the ball. No one behind except the Glenelg players. Stephen Hay again slipped over. Maynard. Stephen Kernahan tears off. The ball coming back. He's offline. Only the point. They both believe that it was a goal, but nothing matters, fellas. 17-14, Glenelg. North 11-10.
Roll up by Moston Rutter, a very experienced umpire, was right underneath the post, but the Bay players thought it was home. Unfortunately, they don't count in the decision. Phillips lost the footy, but he's going to get it back again, plus 15 metres. Elects to play on now as he chips out the pass to Retton on the half-forward line. Retton looking for a running player. Hart is there, but he can't get it to him, so the big fellow's going back to kick long. Off goes Bennett into the pocket, but North Adelaide, not being very direct, have gone to the half-forward flank and find Robinson out there. Bennett's in the pocket. He doesn't want that player. He's going in high. leaves it for Brealey. Brealey in front, got his hands to it. Hedwood back in defence, whips out the handball, Jarman, and now Bennett off the boot and out of bounds. The throw in the full forward left pocket, 17-14 to 11-10. 15 minutes gone in the final quarter. Hedwood 29 and Seabone against Brealey. Bennett on an angle, got out the handball. Gee, took his time, but I don't think the umpire's going to fail. I think he said holding the ball. It was a walking goal for Sanders, but the umpire has ruled that he was holding the ball, and Scott Salisbury gets the free kick in the back pocket.
The umpire's given 15 metres for North Adelaide playing on. I think it might be wrong to assume that players can always hear the whistle. Nevertheless, it's a Glenelg free kick to Wayne Stringer, and he'll kick to the outer side of the ground, looking for Big Carey out there, but Marshall got up very early. The umpire's called play on. Salisbury, McDermott, plenty of run late in this game. Off he goes. Now McGuinness, fastest player on the ground, goes through half forward, brings it up high. Garton, off hands. Maynard lost possession, and North Adelaide will bring it away. Matthew Campbell tapped it back to Robert Kidney. Gee, not the best defensive move. Watch Simons. Up he went with one hand, couldn't take the mark. Well done by Arnold.
The Zuchins came off the interchange bench when North Adelaide lost Rudy with that mouse to the eye. Kernahan again, got his hands, couldn't complete it. High tackle on Jarman, holding the ball. Didn't quite see it that way. I think I've got a few supporters out there. Duthie, half forward left flank. Kick into the pocket. Riley, Stephen Riley. Matthew Campbell hasn't played a bad game. Goes to the half forward line. Stringer, and the umpire will come in and bounce right in front of us at the grandstand. 17-14, plays 11-10.
40 points the difference. We're approaching 17 minutes of this last quarter now. Brealey in front. Hart. Very close to the line. It may roll out. No, it hasn't. The umpire is going to bounce it again. Didn't see that, Robert. What was it?
I think Alan Stringer just might have put his foot in the wrong place then, accidentally, as he walked over the top of that play. They weren't too happy. Darryl Hart not impressed at all.
Glenelg had top players. Kernahan with 5 goals. Copping with 4. With 3, should I say. Garton with 4. So it's been in that forward line where Glenelg have had powerful goal kickers. 3 of them. Kernahan, Garton and Copping, where they've really set up an ascendancy. Carey's been a good ruckman. They've had good contributors all around the ground. Here they go again. Seabone picks up. Salisbury. Maynard. Glenelg building again. Kernahan next. This could be number 6 for the champ. It is. 6 goals, Stephen Kernahan. Glenelg 18-14. North Adelaide 11-10.
Stephen Hay left in the wake then. Ball just over the top. Hay drawn up the ground. Kernahan just dropping back into the spot to receive. So a great game by Stephen Kernahan with 6 goals, 3 from centre half forward. It's a magnificent performance in anyone's language. 9 shots for goal, let alone all the other play he's performed. His ability to get to the ball, his ability to run to both sides of his body is an absolute treat. He's a big, strong man now, with only 22 years of age, just an out-and-out champion, a great player.
The Bays have put Hedwood into the ball ring now, giving him a run on the ball, and he's like a dog that's been let off the leash. He got it down there to McGuinness. Here's a chance for the Bays to get another one. Tony Hall shoots. I think he's got another one. Oh, what a goal off his left foot. The Bays can do no wrong. They're walking on water. The Bays 19th at the 19-minute mark, 19-14 to North Adelaide, 11-10.
Well, Tony Hall really was determined to get that goal. Peter Marker told me that Glenelg had win by 10 goals. He's right on the ball at the moment. They've got about 5 points to make to do the job. That was a great individual effort then by Tony Hall as he spun around onto his left leg. He ignored everything, just sheer determination to make sure that they're going to go all the way with this grand final. Something that the Glenelg haven't been too good at, even though they've been in more finals and played more winning finals games. Grand finals have eluded them. They've won two since 1934, 34 being their first. They're certainly going to win this one.
Glenelg, they want to win it by 22. They're playing pretty well. They're still doing everything as they were in the first quarter. Tiller. Could be one of the softest free kicks we've seen today. Against Alan Stringer, Tiller with the ball on centre wing. Kicks it up to half forward. Andrews behind, and comes over the top. Kernahan, that is David coming back on. Jarman didn't get a good bounce. The ball was kicked away from him. Now Scott Salisbury. Will try and set it up from the outer side. Kidney off. David Kernahan back on. Maynard. Smothered. Well done by Robertson. Back on the ball now. Pass off to Hill. Now Phillips. North now with a chance to run it through half forward. Gee, there's no one home. No one home at all. No one at full forward, so he had to go short.
Pretty popular, this fellow.
Yes, he wouldn't want to stand for politics, would he?
I don't know.
He's at centre half forward. Short to Andrew Jarman, who I think copped a pretty solid whack in the preliminary final last week in the last quarter, and may have been a fairly well-kept secret, I think, at Prospect. About a couple of players who were carrying pretty hard injuries. Nevertheless, he's got the ball and disposed of it 28 times per match this year. He's missed another one. That's 4 points he's kicked, and he missed a very important one late in the second quarter.
21 minutes gone. Into the final 10 minutes of 1985 season. Fine kick out by Seabone. Dropped by Salisbury. Good tackle put on him by Robertson. He's lost the footy. Robertson from the half forward line. Got Bennett up full forward. Not a lot of run in the North Adelaide side now. Pretty dispirited. When they look at the scoreboard, you can understand why. Here's a chance. Hart snaps, but he's going to be well offline and out of play on the full. Seabone to take the free kick. As the player's just going through the motions now. Fine kick out towards centre wing, looking out there for Henwood over the top. Red still giving his all, but not enough. Up forward line, looking for a running player. He goes for Bennett in the pocket. He'll get a leap away, got his hands to it, couldn't complete it. Quickly now Robertson whips out a long handball. This is Bennett. Back now. Hart, Robertson, Bennett, left leg, coming in towards Carey, who takes the mark, a centimetre out. Not a bad shot.
That was close, almost there. North Adelaide have in fact scored only 4 goals since the 14-minute mark of the second quarter. So clear has gone Glenelg dominance been since that time. Red punches away. McGuinness scouts the pack beautifully and then kicks long again. Simons in a good spot there, but didn't quite judge it well enough. Kicking in danger rule against the armfield, against the North Adelaide halfback armfield, and Tony Hall's free kick. It's one they don't pay that often these days. Most players put that one out of their armoury. Tony Hall at centre half forward puts it long into the square.
Play by North Adelaide, and play they went the ways. It's a beautiful teamwork. So Kernahan with 14 kicks and 11 marks, even in the grand final, he's maintained his great performance of marking, something which has been unparalleled. A very great player, Stephen Kernahan.
What a magnificent effort from Stephen Kernahan, considering that for the first quarter, David Wilde did a fine job. Frustrated Kernahan, spoiled at every opportunity, but now the big fella's got back into the goal again with a superb performance. Seven goals. He'll go through, can't get the footy out. Players stack up, and the umpire will come in and bounce the ball again. 2014 plays 11-11. The crowd starting to leave the stands now. The Bays have got it won. Hill used his pace but couldn't get clear. In goes Henwood. And once again, the umpire coming in to bounce the players, just quite content to let the ball be crowded up, bottled up. 2014 into 11-11. The Bays marginally in attack again. Henwood against Redden. Redden comes out for the footy. Campbell, here's a chance for the Bays now through Robertson. Off he bolts. Flanked there by Phillips, but he'll lope over the half forward line. Shoot a long one in towards goal. Umpire said he's home. Robertson's second goal. A fine running effort. But too late for the Northerners. 12-11 for the Bays 2014.
Well, he's one player, David Robertson, has certainly fallen out of the game. Some of his play in the early part was terrific, and he's been a great runner for North Adelaide, but he's one player that they've cut out, Lanil, and he's an important player for the North Adelaide side. That was a great movement there, and typical of the sort of things that he can do, and he did one, of course, early in the game when he ran up the ground. Lanil Gunton's only going to be able to get the highest score in a grand final. That was 24 goals 15 in 1969, but they've certainly played a great game.
McDermott, the centre, long kick to centre-half forward. Kernahan up again in the middle of the pack. I think they all want them up there now. Riley, Hay. Oh, he's kicked it straight to David Kernahan. He wanted to kick to Andrews, but missed. McDermott, Henwood. Big kick a ball out of sight too. That's going straight through. Huge goal, Henwood. He took two places with that and went back. 21-14 for the Elves, North Adelaide 12-11.
Graham Cornes with a little cackle there, because that is a great kick. Just sitting back there meditating. But Wayne Henwood, who was recruited by Glenelg, and he hasn't had all that impressive performances, but then all of a sudden Graham Cornes played him as a knock ruckman. And when he's been in that position, he's performed very, very well indeed. And today he certainly earned his chaff, because he went back into fullback where he held Michael Parsons after a very promising start by the North full forward. And now we see him with a great goal.
Henwood again at the centre bounce, McDermott, the Bays irrepressible at the moment, half forward line, here's a chance, Simons wants running support, no one on him at the moment, goes for home with a long one, just pushed off line, copping in there, can't get it, at the back it's Tony Hall, Garden wants it back again, Hall with a left leg, pushes it towards goal but can't find it, and it's taken in defence there by Trevor Hill. 27 minutes gone. Out of 50,289 witnessing the Bay's first premiership since 1973, the last time it was played at the Adelaide Oval. Antwis, Matthew Campbell, North Adelaide to the half forward line, the ball dropping short. Royally and Stringer get the ball out of play.
Getting pretty close now for the Bay's, probably 2 minutes away, and
the prodigal son has returned.
Coaches are entitled as well with this far in front of him.
First year back at the Bays, Peter, after an illustrious playing career, and he takes him to a premiership.
Andrew Jarman missed with a handball, and away goes Wayne Stringer. Runs through the centre line. Under the ball out there is Garton. Didn't take the mark. Arnold it was who picked it up, and Zuchins will try to run it clear. Armfield delayed the ball to Hay, and now Antibus, he'll get the boo again. I don't think it'll really worry him somehow or other.
I think he should be used to it.
Kicked it straight to Duthie. The Lille players are running around like unregistered dogs out there. There's about five of them. Salisbury, David Kernahan, try David Marshall next. He hooks it back, high and long, but up line.
21-15, Glenelg, North Adelaide 12-11.
Well, the Bays have kicked a few goals this quarter. In fact, they've kicked seven, so there might be plenty of time on. Although we've played about 29 minutes, so it must be close to final siren. Harfield on the half-back line. Put the Northerners towards centre wing. Redden underneath the ball. Stringer the leaper also there was Hay. Bobs off, drives long. Getting underneath the ball, Doothie can't quite manage it. Quickly back now, Hart. Got the handball out. Bennett over to Jarman, now Robertson chips away and goal! He's offline for a point. Well, they're still in there moving the ball around, but since midway through that second quarter they've never really been in.
Ross Gibson kick off. Oh, he's done a dropping. How about that? He's kicked a dropping. He'll get dropped.
No way. Treat to see.
He'll get dropped next week. McDermott's pushed it over the line and there'll be a throw-in.
He won't have to worry about getting dropped next week.
Oh, I haven't seen a drop kick for years.
Lovely to see.
Yeah, I agree, Robert. They should never have left the scene.
Headwood comes in for the big thump. Tries to take it out of the air and then wobbles it forward. Phillips under the ball. He's been one of North's very good players. Now McGuinness. The game running very late. Here it is. Glenelg win it, 21-15 to North Adelaide, 12-12.
What a great performance. Graham Cornes, in his first year back at Glenelg, with general manager Harry Kernahan, the father of David and Stephen, Bob Campbell, the chairman of the club, Penwood happy, Peter Carey, over 300 games, the only player in the side to have played in a previous premiership in 1973, in which Studley Cornes was also a member, and kicked a memorable goal that won the game for the Bays. Everyone excited, and Peter Marker, as a former captain of that side in 1973, how are you feeling right now?
Well, I feel good, Ian. I must say, I'm glad personally that it wasn't close, but it was a very good game. I think that North Adelaide, midway through the second quarter, let it go. I don't think the players were really prepared to work hard enough at that time when they held a five-goal break. But good luck to Glenelg. They worked hard all day. And from coach right through to player number 20, I think they're entitled to be proud of all players. And, gee, they had a few good ones in, and none better than the man running into the pack now, Stephen Kernahan. He may be lost to them next year, but he ended up with seven goals in a mammoth performance at 10.5 balls.
Peter, I don't think he helped South Australia as much. His performance was beamed Australia-wide. I can just see the Victorian scouts, in particular Carlton, who've got him signed, renewing, doubling, trebling their efforts to get him to play in the VFL next year. But it certainly was a wonderful performance. As I said, he was held early, but came into the game magnificently, and it was his resurgence of form in that second quarter that lifted the Bays and took them to the premiership. Excitement all round. Robert Odie, the Bays in the end, they're still fat, disappeared.
They were good. North Adelaide certainly lost their cool during that second quarter. They run over to find the body by hand or kick. They started just to flick the ball around. Come Tony Anthony was a little bit disappointed with the fact that he wasn't able to get clear. And then when he did get possession, he couldn't get it onto a teammate. David Robertson fell out of the game. And the big fellow at full forward, who was unable to get back to get his hands on the wrong ball. That's it. Michael Parsons.
Pam Cornes, Robert, excuse me, butting in. I think Pam Cornes, the wife of the coach, just couldn't contain herself any longer. She jumps the fence. Graham Ferry of sailing fame. Pam Cornes just emotional there. So excited. But now we'll cross to the president of the South Australian National Football League, Mr. Max Bashir.
But the composition of the final five was determined, if you can see what I mean. I congratulate the 10 league clubs on a marvellous season. And I commiserate with North Adelaide, but unfortunately there can be only one winner. Before I ask Peter Carey to come forward to receive the Thomas Seymour Hill Cup, the winner of the Jack Odie Medal for best man on the ground today was Stephen Kernahan. Forward, please.
just want to pay tribute. There's a lot of people involved, but to the 20 guys that played for Glenelg today, we didn't let any of you supporters down. Thank you very much. Congratulations to Graham Cornes, he's done a fabulous job. And view it, it feels tremendous. Thanks very much.
Finish your football season when you've got the opportunity to hoist the Thomas Seymour Hill Cap up above your heads in salute of a great premiership victory. And what a day it has been for Glenelg. They've been here five times at Football Park. They know what it's like to lose, but today they're going through that emotion of winning a grand final. And Graham Campbell, they've been superb throughout the season. What about those two guys on the screen at the moment, McGuinness and Maynard?
Well, yes, it was a real team effort, Rick. The old cliches you could use, every player put in at the right time of the game. They were going down the drain midway through the second quarter, 29 points down, a remarkable comeback. They kicked 7 goals straight during that last 15 minutes of that quarter to put themselves in a winning position at halftime. And all praise to the players and Coach Graham Cornes. They've done it, and they're so hard to win premierships, aren't they? And Glenelg know only too well. As you said, they've been there 5 times prior to today, on Football Park, trying to win one. They've always been the bridesmaid, up until 1985, and they've finally grabbed it. And there's David Holst, the guy that's the fellow holding the cup at the moment. There's a fellow that played in 4 of those 5 losses, I would hazard to say. And we couldn't make the side today, unfortunately, but he's getting something out of it by holding the cup up on behalf of David Marshall. There's a couple of the committee men there too also. Part of the action, but boy, it was a great win, Rick. You can't do much more than what they did. There's Jeff Witham, assistant coach, throwing his arms in the air, and everybody's so excited, obviously.
Turn the game around, Graham, from being 5 goals down at one stage to win by, well, more than 5 goals in the finish. It's a superb effort. But what about North Adelaide? They say you've got to lose a grand final before you can win one, and there must be one around the corner for Mike Nunan and his boys.
Well, I don't know, Rick. They lost touch of the game during that third quarter, and things got a bit tough. They worried too much about evening up with a few fellas out there. I don't know who was in the right and who was in the wrong, but people were going down like 9 pins, and almost on every occasion, North were deemed to be the aggressor. And when that happens, the side don't settle down, they just lose touch of the game, as I said, and couldn't get back into it. I think their last half was abysmal in comparison to their first half, when, as I said, midway through the second quarter, they almost had a grip on the game, which they might have held on to. They could have got another goal. But that's the game. You've got to get those goals when they're needed. They couldn't do it, and down the drain they went, and the further the game went, the more Glenelg were going to win by.
We just saw Stephen Kernahan making his way down the race to, no doubt, some big celebrations in the Glenelg room, and I'd love to know who's got his Guernsey at the moment, Graham, because that number 4 is not on his back anymore, but it would be a prized possession at the moment.
I would say Stephen, he's a gentleman, an absolute marvellous person. I coached him for 2 years down at the Bay, and he's the fellow I love most out of all the players down there. He would have given it to some supporter in the crowd, Rick, I reckon. I had a look at the North Adelaide opponent that stood in today. That was Stephen Hay, the last half. Anyhow, he wasn't wearing it, so he didn't swap jumpers with his counterpart. Consequently, somebody in the crowd probably got it. And I would say Carlton, Stephen Kernahan will go to Carlton now. He has now reached the peak of his football over here. The one thing he wanted was a premiership. He's got it. And I'll say there's no question in my mind that Stephen Kernahan, with 7 goals under his belt, marvellous performance as centre-half forward, he'll go to the VFL next year and stamp his greatness in that competition.
And we could also possibly be saying goodbye to their captain, Peter Carey. Graham, he was a member of that that great grand final side of 73 and the only remaining link with that side out here on the oval today.
Well, Rick, I've got a feeling Peter will carry on now. I mean, he had a big say in the win. Let's be honest about it. His other 2 finals this year weren't all that great for him. He was on the bench for a while during the qualifying final. He didn't have a lot to do in the second semi, but today he was a great player. He won knockouts. He steadied the ship when it was there to be steadied. He took the timely mark. He does it so well, Peter Carey. I'd say there's a year left in the man, and I think he might carry on, especially if Stephen Kernahan does finally go to the VFL.
Do you see any decisive moves during the game, Graham, which really tipped the scales in Glenelg's favour? Coach Mike Nunan made perhaps a strange move of taking Andrew Jarman away from centre when he was winning control of the ball.
Sure, I thought it was a blunder. Andrew Jarman went to a half-forward flank and finally to a forward pocket. He had a run on the ball, but that's not his caper. He likes playing in the middle of the ground. He's a marvellously skilled player, Jarman. I just thought his effectiveness was dulled by being taken out of the middle. And the fellow that went into the centre, David Sanders, isn't really a league centre man. He plays well, but that was the one blunder I noticed.
We'll take a short break and then we'll return to the winning Glenelg rooms with Ian Day and Peter Marker. Football Park, and Coach Graham Cornes has just released his players from behind locked doors, and what a night it's going to be for celebrations down at the Bay today. And I would say one of the most emotional scenes at Football Park today would have to have been when the wife of Coach Graham Cornes, Pam Cornes, dashed out onto the oval. With Pam Cornes down in the rooms at the moment is Ian Day.
Pam, congratulations. How do you feel?
Oh, just so proud.
I didn't see you having a little tear out there on the ground, did I?
Yeah, so proud of them all.
Tell me, how did Studley behave during the week? Was he unbearable or pretty good?
A little bit tense the last 2 days, but he's been very good. Very confident.
constant through the whole year, win, lose. He's been great.
And what's this women's liberation? They let all the women in the room.
No, he invited us back in. Win, lose or draw, we're invited back in.
Don't you have a little peek when they get undressed, will you?
Well, that's all right.
Congratulations. Well done, Pam.
Okay, beautiful.
If I can beat all the females. You ready? Stephen Kernahan. Congratulations, Stephen. How do you feel?
Oh, great, Dages. It's something we worked a long time for, and I've lost two before, but today we all just put it together, made up for those other ones. It's a magnificent feel.
In that first quarter, David Wilde was making a bit hard for you, mate. Frustrated you?
Oh, yeah, you know, I expect that at grand finals. It's never as, it's always a lot harder. There's more pressure on it. Oh, yeah, he put the pressure on me, but, you know, you just work and hope that it comes and all the boys pull together and we manage to get out of it.
It was about in the middle of that second quarter when you started to grab a few. You were down by 29 points. It wasn't looking good for a while there.
Oh, well, we started getting the ball on. We fiddled around a lot and our forward lines opened up and then Garts and Coppo got a couple of goals and everything just started firing from there, and our third quarter was absolutely superb, I thought.
Yeah, third quarter into the breeze. When did you think you actually had it won? What did Graham say to you at three-quarter time?
Three-quarter time, well, you know, we just kicked six into that wind and he told us North can do that easily, but, you know, we stuck to our guns in the last quarter. We played out right to the end and, you know, we got our just rewards.
You know what you did, you rotten buggy? You showed everybody in the eastern states how well you can play. Now we're going to keep in South Australia now.
I don't know, Dave. I'll celebrate for a while. I'll worry about it later.
Stephen, congratulations. Thanks. A fine performance. Well done. Who else we got? Rick Keegan. You can hack it. I can't hear us all speak, mate, up there.
Daisy, once again, working extremely hard down there in the dressing rooms. The only thing he's missing out on at the moment is he hasn't had the champagne tipped over his head as he did so ceremoniously last year in those Nord rooms. But congratulations to Glenelg. A fine effort by them this afternoon. They know what it's like to lose grand finals here, but they've won the grand final of 1985. Well, that just about wraps up football for the season. We sincerely thank you for your company throughout the minor round and also throughout the finals. Until then, this is Rick Keegan on behalf of the entire Seven commentary team bidding you farewell on grand final day, and we look forward to your company in 1986.
Another tiger, you're no good to me. The Westies are small and the Norwoods are tall. At the Barney, we tigers, the pride of them all. How's that? I'd now like to call on Bob Campbell, our president, who would wish to say a few words. Bob, I'm sure. Thanks, Bob.
Thank you, Grandfather. Grandfather Kernahan. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like all of you to toast Graham Cornes, the match committee, and the players. Please be upstanding. Our coach and the players. For they are jolly good fellows, for they are jolly good fellows, and so say all of us, hip, hip, say all of us, and so say all of us, for they are jolly good fellows, for they are jolly good fellows, for they are jolly good fellows, and so say all of us, hip, hip, hooray! Hooray! Ladies and gentlemen, I know Cornsy won't really appreciate this, but Malcolm Whitford did say to me tonight, would you please give Graham all my best because I was the guy that made him a coach. And I know Graham won't admit to that. On a lighter note again, the director for Central Districts said to me, and I guess when you win, it's a little bit like dreamland, isn't it? You think, is it really happening to us? And I know tomorrow morning we'll all realise that it has happened to us. And I said to Rex Chidley, that's almost a bit like dreamland. And he said, well, you don't have to pinch yourself because it really has happened. All I like to say to Marlene and you is that if you enjoy yourself tonight, don't get Marlene pregnant. Thank you, guys. Thank you, administrators. Thank you, guys, all round, for what you've done for the Glenelg Football Club today. And then more importantly, to look at Super Carey down there, it must be wonderful for Linda and Super. Well done, Glenelg Football Club, in 1985. Thank you, Harry.
Grandfather, could I cover me?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, of course, it's my pleasure to call on our coach, Graham Cornes, who wants to make some presentations for today's game and, as he mentioned to the club a few weeks ago, an overall major round presentation to players. And I know that you'll give Graham your greatest attention, and the players that come up to receive those awards. Here he is, Graham Studley Cornes.
Thank you. We're going to award 8 trophies, which I haven't got, the value of which I don't know, but you'll have to trust us, we'll sort it out next week. Best players today were difficult, but we narrowed it down to 8, and you know, one of the things that I've always noticed about finals and the ones that are won when you're behind, and there's always players emerge from nowhere, and we had one of those today. Our 8th award went today to Robin Kidney. Oh, he's cramped. One of the girls want to rub his leg? We've got a few trainers here, haven't we? Where are you?
I've got nothing for you, just you'll get it, so just...
Who do I thank?
Who does he thank?
Who donated it?
Thank the donor.
I'd like to thank the donor of the trophy tonight. Whoever it is. Also, Graham and the match committee for giving me this great opportunity. I didn't get to play in the first 2 finals, but I busted my guts just to get there, and I was all fulfilled today, and I'll remember this for the rest of my life. Thanks very much.
Our 7th award, I mean, everybody deserves them, but really this guy has done so well for himself and really does deserve it. Went to Alan Stringer.
Thanks, lad. Gee.
Thanks, Graham. I'd like to thank Harry Kernahan and Bob Campbell back in early 83. Brother and I were trying to get a clearance from North Adelaide, I think it was, and Bob does quite a bit of running, and I remember him telling me that, he said, we've got a chance. These blokes have, you know, been hanging around for about 4 months, sorry, and they come good with the tricks, and we were lucky enough to get a clearance, and there's not much more I can say, I guess. Thanks to Graham, the coach, and the 20 other guys, trainers, and John McFarlane,
He's helped me a heck of a lot over 3 years, and especially the last month. Thank my wife, I guess, Robin. You've really settled me down, I guess. thanks to Bleth, who's been tremendous over 3 or 4 years, and I guess it's time for someone else to get up here. Thank you.
Okay. Well done. So sort of like a fairy tale, isn't it, for those two guys? Yeah, sixth trophy went today to... I don't know how you got there, Soup. I've got to say you weren't in my... Did you see? He only had 3 kicks, but he had a tremendous influence on the game. It was Peter Carey.
Well, I sort of feel reasonably happy at the moment. It's been a pretty good day. I remember at the end of the game, Graham's called us into the little room that he gives all the talks, and I thought, here we go again. He's going to tell us to take it easy and get ready for next year. Every week it's been the same old thing. As all he said is, don't get carried away, boys. A few more games to go. Well, we're here, we've done it, and, you know, all I can say is that I'm fantastically proud of the 19 other guys that went out there today. And I really feel for the other guys that couldn't make it, you know, the Dennis Russells and the Mark Hewitts that were injured earlier in the year, and the other guys, Walshy and... all the other guys that have been a part of the side during the year. It's been absolutely fantastic. You know, the team spirit at the club hasn't been bettered this year, and, you know, I've been proud to be a part of it. Well, where do we go from here? The Ramsgate? No. Where have you been there? No, it's, you know, I'll probably have a few more words to say tonight, but I'd like to thank everyone that's been a part of it. It does take a hell of a lot of people to, you know, get us out in the field, and, you know, from the administration right through, you know, to the trainers, and, you know, I really think that the trainers put in so many hours for so little reward, really, and it's fantastic to see them here tonight, and I really think they deserve a special thanks. Well, I'm sort of running out of things to say, so I might wind it up. Oh, sorry. Thanks very much to the trophy donor, and how much was it, Graham?
It will be huge.
It'll be huge, Graham told me. Well, it's been a huge day, and absolutely fantastic, and I couldn't be happier. Thanks very much.
Well done, Soup. It actually wasn't your turn to make a speech at that stage. Our fifth trophy went to Peter Maynard. I took him off just before three-quarter time, and he was just at me and at me and at me. I had to put him back in the last quarter just to get rid of him. Wow, 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 wow.
Thanks, if I'd had my way, I probably would have come on a little bit earlier, and I did in the last quarter. I remember Kernahan went down. We kicked a goal, and Kernahan was down on the ground. Even Stully was saying, what are you doing? Get up, get up. And I'm saying, he's crook, hit him off, get him off. And I don't know, I just fancied myself a 10-hour forward. Closing stages, no. I didn't mind going off, because at that time I don't think I was feeling too well. But to get back on the ground, I don't think I could have stood. Sitting there in the last quarter, sort of when, you know, the game's not won till the final bell, but
I was getting to you, Murph. He wouldn't shave me, but I tried to, when he came off, I tried to sort of just pat him and say, well done. He kept running the other end of the bloody interchange, but I just, like everybody, just like to sort of thank everybody that had a part of that, especially the blokes that trained. And like I know, I live with Walshy, and I know the sort of pain and that those blokes went through. Mark Motlop on Thursday night was a shattered man, to say the least. And to all those blokes, as much as you don't feel a part of it, I really want them to feel a part of it and enjoy it as much as everybody else. Special thanks to Cornsy, who's been tremendous. He really has put in a lot of work, and he's kept everybody's feet on the ground. And also a special thank you to Jeff Blethen, who's, I know it's been a personal interest, but he's had a lot to do with me this year, in the first half and in the second half of the year, and with some advice, and even some advice as close as yesterday. And I really appreciate that, Jeff. And I'm just thankful that everybody here that has waited so long, Snout, the older people, everybody that has just waited so long for this, I'm glad we could do it for you. Thanks.
We can't wait. It's not that bad, is it? Our fourth best today goes to a player who started the season under enormous pressure. There's no doubt about that. And has played under enormous pressure all year, and there's no doubt he really has lifted himself back to the champion status. And again, his game as it has been right throughout the series and year was excellent. It goes to Tony McGuinness.
Yeah. I'll just pull this down, all right? I'd like to just say that today was certainly a wonderful experience. I've never seen a bunch of guys cry so much as in the last quarter when it looked like that we obviously had the game won, and every guy that I went up to had cried at some stage, and it was some experience, believe me. I'd like to thank Graham for his help through the year. He's been a wonderful help. I'd like to thank the other 19 guys who played today, who are the best bunch of blokes that you could possibly want to play with. I feel really sorry for the guys that didn't play today, and Walshy sitting there, he was crying after the game, and I guess all the other guys were as well. And I feel really sorry for them that they couldn't be a part of the 20 today and to experience what us blokes were lucky enough to. And to all the rest of the coaching staff and everybody else who is a part of the Glenelg Footy Club today and has been, I guess, since we last won one in 1973, and it's been a long time since then, I guess, and it's a wonderful feeling. Thank you very much.
Great, isn't it? Number three. He was our biggest challenge all year, this guy. And I couldn't work him out. I don't know whether I still have. But his game today and his game all over the finals has been fantastic. It's Wayne Henwood.
I don't really know what Graham meant by that. But I'd like to thank very much Harry Kernahan and Ed Betro for coming over to WA and dragging me over here. And I haven't regretted it one inch. It's been the best move I've ever made. And to Michelle, who came over with me It's been very hard, but we got there with all these people. I know everyone in this room now, and somewhere along the line they've helped me out. And it's just a great feeling to win a premiership. I've never won one before. I've played in a lost one. And to all the guys, it's just great. Thank you.
We've got two left for today, and as I said, we can only give eight. There was guys who missed out and really deserved them, but you've got to cut it off somewhere, but I don't really think they care because it's the premiership. You've got it. No one else can take it off you, and you'll have it for the rest of your lives. We've got two left, and only one guy would have done a drop kick. Only one guy would have the audacity to do a drop kick. And what's more, it hit the other player right on the chest. Ross Gibbs, what a great year he's had.
Well, you know, everybody said it tonight. It's one of those feelings that I think every player will never forget. You know, I'd like to thank a lot of people, like everybody said. I'd like to thank Studley, of course, and all the match committee, Harry Kernahan, and like Wayne said, for pulling me over from the West. Like, the main one I'd like to thank, you know, last year I was probably at the crossroads. I didn't know what was happening. And I'd like to sincerely thank my wife. She's obviously settled me down. And, you know, she's been absolutely unbelievable. What, you know, let's face it, to all the girls, what they've got to put up with. But to you, Julie, you know, I love you very much. Thank you very much. To all the players. To all the players, you know, not only the 20 players that ran out on the ground to, you know, the other 40 players that started the year. Thank, you know, it must be hard for them. You know, you're all part of it, you know, as long as we can all celebrate tonight. And to everybody, the whole Glenelg Footy Club, thank you very much for making my wife and myself very welcome, and who knows, let's do it again next year. Thank you.
Okay, we've got one left. Thought he started slowly today, I was going to drag him. But seven goals later, and another big effort, and I mean, you know how good he is, I know how good he is, and I know how proud we all are of him, and I know how proud Annette and Harry are of him, and with every due reason. And he is the true champion of our club, and that's Stephen Kernahan.
Thanks very much for the award, and you know, first of all, to all the boys that are out there today, we did it for the club. That's what we're out there for. To the guys that trained with us, there's say about 30 of us. I mean, they're as much a part of it today as we were, and I thank them for the, you know, their support out on the track. To the coaching staff, Studley, who's, you know, really moulded us into a top unit. We kept our feet on the ground all year, and we had one main aim, and we, you know, succeeded in that today. You know, I've reached, that's my ultimate goal today. I've wanted for so long to play on the premiership side with this club, and I lost two grand finals, 81, 82, and I was wondering whether I ever would. And today, to do it with these blokes who, you know, we are that close, it just made me feel very proud, and thank you very much.
We had the Warren Brown silly Pete posture, whatever it is. Can we have a different award next year for this? Is Brownie here? He probably is. Is Brownie? And one vote went to Alan Stringer for that award today. Two votes went to Wayne Henwood, and without a doubt, our best team man award vote went to Peter Carey. And I'll try and wind it up, but we did have this player of the series thing, which I think is significant because it wasn't over until today. And some of them have been up, and I think there's three guys in the first eight as the votes went who haven't been up, and they can come up because they'll get an award too. And the eighth best player in the best player award over the series of the finals was won by Tony Simons. And our seventh best player award over the series was won by Chris McDermott. Over the series was won by Stephen Copping. That's 11 guys that we've acknowledged tonight. We used 21 players over the finals, and you know, it's difficult for some guys to get acknowledgement when they're asked to do a specific job. You know, if I just pull a name out of the air like John Seabone, who plays at centre half back and wasn't beaten in any of his games, and similarly Chris Duthie, the likes, and I can't remember him being beaten in the final series, and that's just another couple. But there's 21 guys, and have been used. 20 share it today. I thank the other guys. No, it's not the same. We've all said that. But what I really want to say to you is, again, to the guys, is thank you. And to all of us who are going to be observers and sometimes participants in their shenanigans over the next week or so, just please try and understand the pressure they've been under. And please, please help them enjoy themselves. Thanks very much.
BGFC, our golden black colours, a picture to see. We're dashing, we're gay, we're the pride of the bay. Our war cry strikes fear in the team that we play. A tiger for me, a tiger for me. If you're not a tiger, you're no good to me. The Westies are small, the Norwoods are tall, and the Bonnie Wee Tigers, the pride of them all. Our Leafsides, our Chickens, our Thirds, and our Colts will play for their colours no matter results. We'll thrash them, we'll slay them, they're down by the sea, and roar out our chorus for each team to see. A tiger for me, a tiger for me. If you're not a tiger, you're no good to me. The Westies are small, the Norwoods are tall, and the Bonnie Wee Tigers, the pride of